This is a production of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, made possible by the Friends of SDPB. Pledge your support for quality programming. Call Friends at 800-333-0789 or donate online at sdpb.org. You may purchase this video and many others online at our website. Click on Shop SDPB. And thank you.
This high school activities championship event is conducted under the auspices of the South Dakota High School Activities Association.
And good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the Dakota Dome in Vermilion, the second day of the South Dakota High School Football Championships here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. I'm Steve Toome, along with Gary Ellenbolt, Mike Hendrickson joining us here this morning. Craig Maddock will be joining us later on in the day. We have another three games on the schedule for today. The first matchup, the 9B contest between Hamlin and Avon. And Gary, we had some great football yesterday. Some records fell. A thriller in the nightcap yesterday of the first three games of the Dakota Dome played yesterday. Another three coming your way today. But that first game yesterday, Potter County and Leola Frederick, records fell.
And Potter County sending the message early on that very play as they got the long touchdown pass. Just caught Leola Frederick a little bit flat-footed on the play. And really never looked back from there. 466 yards on the through the air, 8 touchdown passes.
Here's a
key
fumble
recovery that got them their touchdown in their second possession. And again, just open it from there. There is the pass right over the defenders. Beautiful pass and a touchdown.
It was 13-0 early, and I think the Titans were a little bit shell-shocked as Chase Hall going deep once again. Hewer with the catch. Again, getting behind the defense. And on long pass, I think it was like 5 or 6 drives that Potter County had yesterday were either 1 or 2 plays. And here's another pass. Roush, another catch for a touchdown. And for Chase Hall on the day, 466 yards, 8 touchdowns. Those are all-time, all-championship records. Potter County rolls 60-22. When these two teams played in the regular season, it was a 12-7 game, but the offense was definitely on display yesterday at the Dakota Dome, and you see Hall's numbers there. Just a fantastic. Tanner Hewer there, 2 yards shy of the all-time receiving record. He's got the 9-man championship game record. Came up just a couple yards short of Derek Oldert's record from Rapid City Stevens back in 94. And Dane Campbell with a good game yesterday for Leola Frederick. We move on. The 9AA championship game followed the 9A championship game yesterday. That was between Arlington and Bridgewater Emory Ethan. The Cardinals coming in with high hopes. They haven't been to the Dome in a few years, but it was Mr. Shape getting an interception. He fumbled it, but got it back, and that set up the Seahawks.
Good presence of mind for J.D. Shape. And there is Wade Miller getting the first of his 3 touchdowns on the game. Second one coming to Miller as he scoots toward the corner. He's able to get it, get the pylon, and he just had a magnificent day. In fact, named the Joe Robbie most valuable player.
Mr. King tried to bring him back, Andrew King, but here is a key play. Arlington stopped on the goal line. And then Barcher went to Shape for a touchdown pass. One of the few passes thrown by the Seahawks, but it was effective. That ground game for Bridgewater, Emory, Ethan, their bread and butter. Their defense was standout too. Again, turning away Arlington inside the 5-yard line.
And a nice interception. Good presence of mind by Wade Miller. Saw the ball in the air. Great reaction and able to get the interception. And that pretty much sealed the deal because it would have been a 38-30 ball game with the touchdown and had Arlington made the 2-point conversion. It would have been
30-20, I believe, yeah. Had Arlington gotten those touchdowns when they were inside the 5-yard line. Wade Miller and Jordan Gross-Didier, a great 1-2 punch for the Seahawks. Andrew King did everything he could. He accounted for most of the offense for the Cardinals. just wasn't enough as Bridgewater Emery Ethan pulls away late to claim the 9AA championship. And then we move on to the nighttime session, and what a game it was last night here at the Dakota Dome, the 11A championship game. West Central, who's been here so often they could probably have their mail delivered here, against Madison, their first time at the Dakota Dome. The Trojans in the unfamiliar role of the underdog. Here's a little screen pass. Millen with the catch and then the great run, using his great speed, just outran the defense, pulled away from a couple of defenders, and early on the Bulldogs had the lead, but back come the Trojans. They went to their vaunted running game. We got a touchdown there.
It's something they've been doing for years, to just play try and stop us football. Madison coming close. Here's Millen once again with the touchdown. Rush Millen, an outstanding player, great center of gravity, and did a nice job on that touchdown as well.
And here's one of the key plays in the game, the quarterback being sacked for Madison. Ill-advised pass, thwarted a drive, and that set things up a little bit later on in the game after the teams exchanged punts. The halfback pass with 19 seconds left. Cody Bussell, the catch, the touchdown. West Central, their 12th championship in thrilling fashion over a Madison team that had been unbeaten. Jacob Giles had a good game rushing, passing, but boy, Madison was shut out in the second half. West Central, their defense was just stellar in the second half.
And you're not going to ask much more of Jacob Giles. Look at the day. He had 234 yards and 12 of 22 passing in the touchdown, 41 yards on the ground with one touchdown. But, you know, West Central always seems to find a way to get it done once they get in the Dakota Dome, and did again. And we're setting up for some really good games today as well. 1-9B and then 11B and 11AA by the time we're done tonight.
Canton and Parkston, that'll be the second game of the session today. And then at 7 Central, 6 Mountain Time tonight, it's Pier versus Watertown for the 11AA championship. Tomorrow night, our coverage begins at 7 Central, 6 Mountain Time, the 11AAA championship. Sioux Falls Roosevelt taking on Sioux Falls Lincoln. Let's take a timeout and come back, get you set up for this 9B championship game. The Chargers of Hamlin, the Pirates of Avon coming up in a few minutes right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
And welcome back to the Dakota Dome. I'm Mike Henriksen from SportsMax Radio and calling all sports. Thanks so much for joining us here for South Dakota High School Public Broadcasting's coverage of the state championships. A lot of the questions involve why Hamlin is playing in the 9B game. Here's the setup. Everything that happens for the activities in South Dakota is based on the ADM. That's the average daily membership. And that's what determines which schools go into which class. However, schools are able to petition, due to special circumstances, into different classes. And that's why Hamlin, who has the same ADM as Aberdeen-Roncalli, who's a traditional power in 11B, Hamlin is A in everything else, in all of their volleyball and basketball and track and et cetera. However, in football, they have a very large population in the Hamlin School District that, due to religious reasons, does not participate in extracurricular activities. And so consequently, what happens is that hurts their numbers severely when it comes to football. And as we all know, football especially is a numbers game, not so much with the other sports and activities. And so consequently, Hamlin went to the state of South Dakota. They were able to petition to say, listen, we've got these bodies in our hallway, but we don't have them on our field. And so they petitioned. That petition was granted. And so you have a school that is by far and away clearly a Class A school playing all the way down in 9B football. And so we'll also see a similar situation later on today with Watertown, who petitioned down from 11AA down to Class 11A. But that's why Hamlin is playing for a 9B championship, despite the fact that they are Class A in all of their other sports. So with that, let's send it back on up to the booth. I'm Mike Henriksen. Guys, Looking forward to a great day of football today.
All right, thanks, Mike, and thanks for that explanation there. And that's something I've had fans ask me, too. And, you know, it's like, yeah, how come this school is playing in this class? But there you have the reason why. It's just another reason why school administrators have such a tough job.
Indeed. And you look at the Hamlin School District, it actually is comprised of four or five communities in Hamlin County, which is, you know, south of Watertown. A little bit. And with the enrollment, you combine all of those communities' enrollment, of course, of all the kids, then the ADM is figured out from there. But again, there are circumstances that apply, and Hamlin has one of those.
Let's meet, actually, the team Hamlin is going to be playing today, the Avon Pirates. They've been a traditional power for the last decade in nine-man football. They come in to this year, or to this matchup, I should say, unbeaten. And with a team that loves to run the football, the Avon Pirates are coached by Tom Culver, and we caught up with him earlier this week.
We like to run the football, and our kids believe in it, and they want it. Do it, you know, and we've had, you know, even with quarterbacks, sometimes, you know, quarterbacks like to throw it around a little bit and stuff, but I give our quarterback quite a bit of freedom. He can audible, he can do different things, and then, you know, he has to make reads on the option on the move. And so, I mean, they even like that too, so that they don't mind, you know, running the ball, and they've all bought into it. So, I mean, good kids that lift weights and work hard and that really believe in what we're doing, I think, has been the key. Two kids that have been our real leaders this year, Brandon Kutzmick is our running back and one of our linebackers. He's 6'3", 200 pounds, plus, you know, last spring at the state track meet, he got third in the 400. So he's got some speed and, you know, some endurance. And I mean, he's averaging 15 yards a carry this year. He's got like 1,839 yards. Devin Talsma is our other, he's our second leading rusher. He's over 1,200 yards this year, plus he's averaging about 18 tackles a game, and he's in on a lot of plays. But, you know, other thing, our linemen have done a great job this year, both offensive, defensive line. They've really stepped up, and, you know, our backs will be the first ones to tell you there's been some pretty good holes there at times. And then the backs do a great job of blocking for each other. Logan Mutter has been our quarterback and defensive back, and he's kind of led the offense and has really come on here lately and played a lot more physical and you know, made some good reads on our option and, you know, audible when it calls for it. And so those guys have done an outstanding job so far this year. I think that's going to be a key for us is what we've done all year long is try to be the most physical team. You know, we've preached to our kids and they've done a great job of executing. I mean, we just are pounding on people offensively and defensively. And, you know, eventually, you know, some kids handle it pretty well and some get tired of it. And you can see it in the second half of games sometimes. And so that's kind of what our focus and goals are.
Tom Culver, the head man for the Avon Pirates, a school located in the southeast part of the state. They've had a lot of success on the football field. There you see red and gold, their colors. 56, their ADM. They have bounced back and forth, actually, between 9A and 9B over the years. They've kind of settled into 9B the last few years.
And they've been successful just about anywhere they've gone. They have made several appearances at the Dakota Dome, running the table in this 2013 season with the start over Burke South Central. First of two meetings with Gregory for the win. Got the Gorillas again in the playoffs, defeated Scotland, tripped Delmont Armor. Three-time defending champ Canastota. Then Gayville Ballin, Marty Indian School, and Andy Central out of Lake Andesa, Charles Wicks County. Defeated the Highlanders in the first round of the playoffs, 46-0. Then got convincing wins over Del Rapids, St. Mary, and Wall to make their way to the Dome for the 9B championship.
Avon, of course, playing a lot of 9A and 9AA schools. That helps them on their PowerPoint ranking. Let's meet the offensive starters for the Pirates. Jacob Knodel, Alex Balvin, Jacob Reeds, brother Josh Knodel, and Clay Lucas, the starting front line. And then Logan Mutter, Devin Tulsa, Brandon Kutzmick, and Cole Beeson in the starting lineup. Expect a lot of time also from Brendan Anderson. He's a sophomore running back, number 22. He'll be in the lineup a lot today as well. On defense, the Pirates will run that five-man front with Canodal, Balveen, Jacob Reeves, Josh Canodal, and Cole Beeson along that front wall. Some of those guys will drop back into a linebacker position. Right. From time to time, but generally it's five men up front for Avon as they concentrate on the run. Active linebackers, Tolsma, one of their leading tacklers, Logan Mutter as well, and Cody Naminga. And then Brandon Kutzmix is the safety, and of course he's got the great speed at that safety position.
And that's a good thing too, because there's only one defensive back that plays in Avon's defensive system. Everybody's either a down lineman or a linebacker from that point.
Let's take a timeout, come back. We'll meet the Chargers of Hamlin in just a moment. This is the 9B Championship football game on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Welcome back to the Dakota Dome in Vermilion. Getting ready for the 9B Championship football game. Battle of unbeatens between the Pirates and the Chargers. We've met the Pirates. Now let's meet their opponents, the Hamlin Chargers, also with a perfect record of 11-0 coming in. School up in the northeast part of the state, just south of Watertown, the Hamlin Chargers, located in Hayti. There you see their regular season record. They had three shutouts to start things off.
That's right, and ended up with four on the season. A very stingy defense, of course, that the Chargers and Jeff Sheehan are bringing down to Vermilion. 12 points against Wilmot, held dual to 12 points, and then Webster area, closest game of the year, 28-20.
Yeah, that was their only time they were really challenged on the regular season. They shut out Castlewood in the playoffs. And then a great matchup with Hitchcock-Tulare, who took them to the limit, 30-22. And then Harding County had to make the long trip across the state, and another shutout for the Charger defense. Hamlin has been playing some great defense. Their head coach is Jeff Sheehan. We caught up with him earlier this week.
It's been one of the best seasons I've had as a coach. I've had the privilege of winning a state title in North Dakota. But this team right here that I'm coaching right now has a lot of heart, and they mimic a lot of what we had up in North Dakota. So I'm excited. It's been a great season. I've had a great coaching staff to work with, and you know, the kids are very well respected, and they respect the coach as well. You won't get the smart mouth comments back. You won't get that stuff from these guys. These guys are. Once we hit the field at 3:45 every day or 4 o'clock, we get to business and we get done, and then we move on to the next day. And, you know, that's kind of how these guys are. They're great kids, and they've worked very hard and, you know, got to where we are because of their abilities to do on the football field. We had a good year last year. We went 8-1 last year, and then this year we started out really well. Undefeated regular season. The crowd kept getting bigger and bigger and bigger as the year goes on to get to the playoffs. You win a playoff game. The next week it's a little bit bigger, you win that one, you know, and the community has been great. The support's been there, you get a lot of thank you notes, a lot of emails, a lot of phone calls. Just stopped out in the community, if you're out and about, people stop you and they say, hey, congratulations, and you know, good luck, you know, we're pulling for you. And you can just, you know, tell that the community is you know, backing you 100%. And the thing that really gets me is the alumni that have come back and said, you know, this is great for our school, you know, and they thank us for doing what we did. And you know, we always put the emphasis back on the players because they're the ones who did all the work and you know, and doing what we ask of them. So, you know, they deserve all the credit. You know, we've done really well all year. I think our highest point that I'll say is it's not really a point during the season. It's just how our defense has been playing all year. Six shutouts we've had this year, so that's pretty impressive for any team. But you know, in the playoffs we've had two shutouts, so that's to us. That's a good. Barometer of where we're at and how our team is made of. We kids believe in the theory defense will win championships, so you know, we put a lot of emphasis on that. And you know, the way I look at it is they believe in themselves and they believe in the team aspect of the game. There's a lot of kids that you see in high school football who are big about themselves and want to make themselves look good, and these guys don't care. On my team, don't care who gets the glory. It's not about that. It's about winning games, and it's about getting to where we are in the state championship game. I mean, that's what their goal's been all year. So they've put the team first, and you know, that's what they go on. You don't see them fighting. You don't see them getting mad at each other. You see them picking each other up. When somebody does something they weren't supposed to, they get reminded, and then we move on. I mean, that's just how they are. So they're consistent. They're hard workers. Since last football season, they've been in the weight room. They've put on a lot of good size and worked on their speed. I mean, they've done all the little things that you need to do to be a good football team, and, you know, and it's paying off for them right now.
That was Coach Sheehan there. Let's meet the starting lineup for the Hamlin Chargers on offense. An undersized line by all accounts. Only one guy over 200 pounds. Lyseth, Ryer, Holsworth, and Buck. The front four there is they only have one end on the starting line. Then it's Grantham, Quarum. There's the 2,000-yard rushers. Neiman at fullback. The wideouts are Koisty and Namkin. And then on defense, they'll have Lyseth, Ryer, Holsworth, Buck, and Grantham in a 3-2 set, or actually 3-4 set with Neiman at a linebacker, and also Cody Naminga, Tristan Namkin, and then Dustin Quarum, their speed guy, with the those are the safeties for the Hamlin Chargers. Let's take a break, come back, get you set up. The 9B championship game coming up in just a moment right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Our only battle of unbeatens the entire weekend will be coming up in a moment here in the 9B championship football game, the first of three on the day here at South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Avon and Hamlin, when we get back here from the timeout, we will have the introduction of the starting lineups, the national anthem, and all the pregame ceremonies. It's something you definitely want to catch, so stay with us. The 9B championship game coming up in just a few minutes, right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Welcome back to the Dakota Dome in Vermilion, just moments away from the start of the 9B championship game between the Hamlin Chargers and the Avon Pirates. Last time the Chargers were here was 1999. They lost to Vermilion in the 11A final. Avon's been a frequent visitor here. Let's get the introduction of the starting lineups. Let's turn it over to our public address announcer, Mr. Greg Merrigan.
The South Dakota High School Activities Association, along with its corporate partners, Sanford Health, First Premier Bank and Premier Bank Card, Farmers Union Insurance, Billion Automotive, and the South Dakota Army National Guard, welcome you to Vermilion for the 2013 South Dakota State Class 9B Football Championship Game. Good sportsmanship is vital at all levels of athletics. The South Dakota High School Activities Association asks that you exhibit good sportsmanship during this Class 9B game. Remember to put students first, be a sport, and support good sportsmanship. At this time, let's meet the cheerleaders for both squads. First for the Avon Pirates, Michaela Glaucheski, Samantha Farr, Courtney Buckholtz, Casey Markle, Chloe Van Gerpen, and Evie Blaha. And now for the Hamlin Chargers, Melissa Smith, Allie Lochness, Mallory Anderson, Molly Koisty, Delana Namkin, Savannah Adams, Allison Frankenhoff, and Macy Troutner. And now let's meet the starting lineups for this championship game. First, the offensive unit for the Avon Pirates. At center, number 71, Jacob Reeves. At right guard, number 34, Alex Balvin. At left guard, number 72, Josh Knodel. At right end, number 5, Jacob Knodel. At left end, number 21, Clay Lucas. At fullback, number 22, Brendan Anderson. At running back, number 26, Devin Tolsma. At running back, number 2, Brandon Kutzmick. And at quarterback, number 3, Logan Mutter. The Pirates are coached by Tom Culver, assisted by Mel Fetke, Matt Yost, Justin Lucas, and Mark Mutter. And now let's meet the defensive starters for the Hamlin Chargers. At defensive end, number 7, Tristan Lyseth. At nose guard, number 22, Dylan Ryer. At defensive end, number 40, Alex Holdsworth. At linebacker, number 35, Brady Buck. At linebacker, number 28, Brody Grantham. At linebacker, number 10, Brody Grantham. At linebacker, number 30, Austin Neiman. At safety, number 23, Tristan Namkin. And at safety, number 24, Dustin Quorum. The head coach of the Chargers is Jeff Sheehan, assisted by Brandon Hoof, Chris Lather, Andrew Johnson, and Brooke Anderson. The officials for this 9B championship game. The referee is Mike Chisholm of Chamberlain. The umpire, Casey Hutmaker of Oklahoma. The head linesman, Steve Peterson of Chamberlain. The line judge, Warren Fries of Chamberlain. And the back judge, Harry Hanen of Chamberlain. And now, ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand as we honor America with the singing of our national anthem. The national anthem will be performed by the Warner High School Band under the direction of Sharon Schwann. We would like to remind all in attendance that proper respect is to remove your cap or hat, face the flag, and stand at attention with your right hand over your heart. Veterans and active military not in uniform may salute the flag. Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem.
Thank you.
We direct your attention to the rafters above the Avon fans. A member of the South Dakota National Guard will rappel from the Dakota Dome roof with today's game ball. And now members of the South Dakota Army National Guard will present today's game ball and a ceremonial coin for excellence for the championship game coin flip. The soldiers of the South Dakota National Guard salute today's players, coaches, and fans for exemplifying excellence in high school activities.
Avon has won the toss. They select to receive. Hamlin will defend the north goal.
Yeah, with the conclusion of the pregame ceremonies, we are getting ready for the kickoff of the 9B championship game between Avon and Hamlin. I love the new thing that the South Dakota Army National Guard doing, rappelling from the roof. I guess you can't be afraid of heights if you do that.
My question is, how does the guy get up there in the first place?
I think they got a catwalk up there, I think.
Okay. All right. So it's not a bunch of guys to try to throw him into the air and hope he grabs a rafter. No, but we do thank the South Dakota National Guard for their service, and they've always been a wonderful supporter of the high school championships here. So the Avon Pirates won the toss. They have made the fairly rare for this day in football move to receive the ball rather than defer to the second half. They want the ball in that high-powered offense hands and see what they can do to win a 9B title.
Cuts Mick back deep to receive the kickoff, and it'll be Granton to kick it off for Hamlin, and it's a squib kick. We are underway with the 9B championship game. Cuts Mick handles it at the 19. Looking for a block, gets one, but can't get to the sideline. Cut down at the 21.
And that's a nice move by Hamlin on defense. Might have been a couple of players close to a block in the back, which is illegal and which happens an awful lot on returns. But they keep Kutzmick to the 21-yard line. Avon, a solid run team, one of those solid teams you'll see in the class, if not the state. That's how they live and die, and they've done it very well for another year, coming in here unbeaten.
They have only attempted 22 passes as a team all year long. This team will live and die today on their running game. No surprise, they go to Kutzmick right away. Can't get around the right corner. Dives out of bounds after a short gain of about 2 yards.
Kutzmick actually got a few more yards than I thought he would. Hamlin's defense, which is very tough, and you saw some of the scores they allowed in the course of the season, really did a nice job of sealing the sideline off. Kutzmick got there just in time to pick up three.
372 yards a game on the ground. That's what the Pirates average. Oh, that wishbone set. Hand off. This is Tolsma, the other 1,000-yard rusher. He'll break the tackle, but only get to the 26.
All eight cylinders so far for the Hamlin defense. Ryder Grantham helping out on the stop for Hamlin High School. It'll be a third down and 5 situation. And really... Avon for the stellar running team. They are not even forced to throw on a third and five. You got to believe they're going to try to keep the run game active here.
Mutter under center. Fake the handoff. Pitch to Kutznick. He's got the corner. He's off and running to midfield. Tripped up in Hamlin territory. Great blocking by Avon. They went to the open side of the field. From the left hash mark, they ran to the right, and that's the speed of Brandon Kutznick on display.
Dustin Quarum getting just enough of the ankle of Kutznick to make the touchdown-saving tackle. Kutznick had an incredible hit of steam and a great job of the option. Here he comes down the sideline, and there's the grab, and a nice one by Quarum. First down and 10, Avon in Charger territory.
They'll go to Anderson on the fullback dive, and he doesn't get much. That is Brendan Anderson, the sophomore, 195-pound fullback.
Grantham and a couple of others getting up off the pile for the Chargers. Tristan Leeseth also making the tackle. Couple of yard gain that time as they go off the right side and basically stymied by the Hamlin defense.
Naminga and Lucas will rotate in and out of the Avon lineup, bringing in the plays from the sideline. They'll be at an in position, tight formation. The run by Mutter stumbles ahead, got tripped up, pulled down at the 37-yard line. Mutter on the year, 65 carries, 458 yards, including a 98-yard run. He has accounted for 6 rushing touchdowns.
Is it true that there's a very distinct society among the Avon team this year that if you make a great play on offense, you become one of Logan's heroes?
That could be. It is third down and 3 for the Pirates. This is the down and distance situation. They don't mind on third down as Kutznick, second man throw. He'll break a tackle. He's towards the sideline. He'll get down near the 20-yard line. First down, Pirates.
Tristan Nankin making the stop for Hamlin as they went off the right side. He's just so fast, and the offensive line is so good, able to clear out the blockers on the left side of the Charger defensive line. Kutznick with a great run, put the ball right at the 20-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for the Avon Pirates.
There you see the replay there. He breaks out of a tackle. Finally, pulled down from behind. First down, Avon in Charger territory. Right at the 20. Tolsma has a hole into the open to the 5. Touchdown, Avon Pirates.
One of the nicest plays you're going to see. An Avon team that's certainly used to that. They do the fundamental things so very well. As you'll see on the replay, fake the handoff one side. Tolsma's coming around the other. He's able to come up with the handoff and nobody near him as they got some nice blocks to the left side of the Avon offensive line. There he goes. And the Pirates get first blood, 6-0 over Hamlin. They'll go for 2.
Which is what they normally have done over the years. Option play, Mutter keeps it. He's in the end zone, 2 points. Or did he fumble it out of bounds? Or fumble it out of the back of the end zone? No,
well,
signal yet.
No, he actually, I mean, I thought he was well over the line.
And it will be good. 2-point conversion will count for the Pirates. So that makes it 8-0. Here is the replay. Let's see. Ooh, he fumbled it. It appeared there he was not over the goal line. And it goes out of the back of the end zone.
Of course, there's no challenge here.
Yep, no instant replay and no challenges in high school football. 7 plays, 79 yards, 2:44 time of possession for the Pirates as they march it down the field with their vaunted running game. And they get a touchdown on their very first drive. So let's see how Coach Sheehan's Chargers will respond when they get the ball. They have a pair of 1,000-yard rushers, too. Quarterback Brody Grantham has run for over 1,100 yards, 15 rushing touchdowns. He's also thrown for 577 yards. And their other 1,000-yard rusher is the running back Dustin Quarum, 1,233 yards, 21 rushing touchdowns. He averages over 7 yards a carry.
There you see 7 play drive, took 79 yards and 244. That's just so typically Avon.
Yes, and they when you have a big offensive line, in this case, 2 very fast running backs in Kutznick and Tolsma, All you have to do for that offensive line is open up a decent hole, and those running backs will get through. Here's the kickoff. And on the return, I believe that's Neiman. And it is. He'll get across the 35 to the 36-yard line. That's Austin Neiman.
Just the fourth return of the year for Neiman. Quorum has done the bulk of the work, but yet they have such a great defense, they don't get kicked to a lot.
Yeah. It's like you only get the kickoff when the other team scores. And Hamlin, they've had a few shutouts on the year. So the Chargers come to the line of scrimmage. They'll work out of the shotgun. Quorum, the lone setback. And it's a direct snap, and it's shut down right away by the Pirates. Quorum got the direct snap and got no gain.
As he went to the left side, Avon smelling it out perfectly. Looks like Avon has a pretty decent defensive game plan. That's kind of hard to tell on one play, I realize, but that time around, Pirates not fooled a bit. No gain, second and 10 for the Chargers.
They go 205, 250, 235, 210 across the front four. Stay line up here. Grantham's going to throw a high arcing pass. He's got a man, but Neiman didn't see it.
Neiman turned around every which way on nice coverage by the Pirates on defense. That was Kutzmick who was trying to provide the defense and did. However, the pass was overthrown, and it would have been tough to connect anyway. Just looking over both shoulders and lost it.
Third down and 10 coming up for Hamlin on their first possession of the game.
And a correction, that wasn't Kutzmick on the defense. That was Logan Mutter from the linebacker spot.
Out of the shotgun. Three receivers in the pattern. Grantham's going to keep it. Can't get away from Kutzmick, who pulls him down at the 40-yard line. Only a gain of about four on the play as Kutzmick came up from his safety position, had his eye on the quarterback the whole way, and makes the tackle in the open field.
Just didn't have a chance to get the corner turned. If he'd gone a little sooner, then maybe, because he had a couple of steps on Kutzmick. But Kutzmick getting there first, making the tackle. Chargers punt.
Grantham the punter. He averages 41 yards a punt. Low snap, not much pressure. Gets it away. And it will bounce. Kutzmick will let it roll. It'll bounce out of bounds. Right about the 18-yard line, and that's where the Pirates will take over.
Ryder Grantham downs the ball for the Hamlin Chargers in the, light blue, call it powder blue, Columbia blue, I guess is the more athletic term for that. Jerseys with white pants and the light blue helmets. Put you in mind of another set of Chargers when they wear those alternate uniforms
it's
a couple times a year.
Yep, San Diego.
The Pirates will start first.
Pirates, they wear the traditional red and gold. They're in the white road uniforms today. First and 10, just across the 18-yard line. Mutter will hand off, second man through. Kutzmick hit hard, maybe a 1 yard gain.
Kutzmick headed toward the right side, left side of the defensive line, able to smell it up. Brady Buck making the stop for the Pirates. From his left linebacker spot, or from his linebacker spot. Buck making the stop, just a yard gain for Kutzmick. Pirates again have the lead with an 8-0 advantage, 7:27 quarter one.
Traditional wishbone set. Tight formation, ends in close. Mutter taking his time. Second man through Tolsma. He knifes through a hole, but just can't break out into the open. He'll get to the 23-yard line. Good tackle there by the Chargers.
Looked like they had a shot at getting there, but Neiman making the stop for the Hamlin squad. Third down, 5. And I think this is a situation that Avon really is pretty comfortable with. Third and 5 never seems to be a big deal to a Tom Culver team.
No, their running game has been so strong over the years that third and 5 would be a passing situation for a lot of teams. Avon's like, yeah, we can get this. They've been so successful with their running game over the years. Second man through Tolsma. Crashes through, and he will be shy of that marker. Pulled down at the 26-yard line.
Ryder Grantham, the linebacker, making the stop as they sent Tolsma left side. Grantham bent a little bit, but the Hamlin defense did not break. It's fourth and a couple, and Kutzmick will kick away the football.
Yeah, he averages 30 yards a punt. He's only punted 18 times on the year. And, of course, with his great speed, you always have to watch out for a fake. Boy, he gets a dandy of a punt there. It angles away, and the return man is just going to let it go for Hamlin. That's Namkin, and a great punt for Avon. Let's take a timeout. We'll come back with more. This is the 9B Championship football game on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Welcome back to the Dakota Dome in Vermilion. I'm Steve Toom along with Gary Ellenbolt. Mike Hendrickson joining us today as well. Craig Maddock will join us a little bit later on this afternoon as we have a second full day of football here at the Dakota Dome. This is the 9B Championship football game between Hamlin and Avon. Pirates up early, 8-0.
11B game coming up at about 2:30 Central Time this afternoon. Canton meeting Parkston. And a fascinating game of football tonight in 11AA. As Pierre will battle Watertown.
Grantham will work out of the shotgun. Quarum the lone back. Again, the direct snap to the running back. This time he has a little bit of a hole to run through. Gets across the 20 to close to the 22-yard line.
And he kind of created some help there, too, as Dustin Quarum took the handoff, went right side. It's a little better situation for himself as he cut to the right. There he goes with the cut. Gets behind the blockers and picks up about 6 yards.
Close to 7 yards on that one. We'll call it second down and three for the Chargers. Grantham on the keeper. He's got room around the corner. He makes it to the sideline. He's at the 40 and Kutzmick, the last man in line, pushes him out. He had to use his great speed to catch up with Brody Grantham, the junior quarterback. Good blocking. They created a hole around the right side, and Grantham took advantage.
Worked the sweep to perfection. Here he comes. He gets the corner a little bit earlier than he had on the first possession. Able to dance around a couple of Pirates. Gets a beautiful run and puts the ball just outside Avon territory at the 47.
First down of the game for the Chargers. Two men out to the right, one out to the left. Typical set that Hamlin will present. Grantham wants the throw, arcs it down the sideline, out of bounds, intended for Tristan Namkin, but nobody was going to catch that one.
And second pass attempt for the Chargers in the game, and the second overthrown pass. As might be expected, Avon does have the yardage advantage. Neither team with any yards through the air. 86 yards of total offense for Avon. That compares to 35 for the Chargers.
Both pass attempts by Hamlin have been deep passes. They have tried to throw the long ball twice early, and it's been overthrown.
And it's almost like they're setting up Avon's defense to kind of get complacent with the run and then try to throw as an element of surprise.
Durham bobbled the direct snap, but he's pulled down after about an 8-yard gain. Boy, that could have been disaster for the Chargers. But sometimes when the timing gets disrupted, it actually benefits the offense. That was one of the rare cases as Kutzmick made the tackle. Watch it. Here's the bobble. Yeah.
And I think everybody just kind of stopped for a second, and that gave Quarum a little bit more room to run. Third down and three is the setup and a timeout called.
Timeout Avon with 4:52 left here in the first quarter of this contest. Don't forget Canton playing Parkston a little bit later on. That'll be our 11B matchup. And then tonight it's Watertown taking on the Pierre Governors. I'd like to remind you that coming up on Saturday night after our 11 AAA football game, we'll have No Cover, No Minimum featuring Cheryl Crow. That was taped this summer at the Sioux Falls Jazz and Blues Fest. There you see Cheryl Crow on No Cover, No Minimum. That will be after the 11 AAA football game on Saturday night right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Did you ever hear the story of All I Want to Do is Have Some Fun?
No, I have not.
A record producer actually found that in a book of poetry and was looking for a song for Cheryl Crow, they contacted the author and said, you know, would you mind if we set this to music? And I said, oh, yeah, that's cool. She had her first hit with it.
Coming out of the timeout, Hamlin faces a third down and two. 8-0 Pirates. Now the shotgun set. They'll put a man in motion. That's Neiman. Two backs now. Neiman the extra blocker. Grantham has a hole. He's into the open. One man to beat. And the tackle made by Avon. But a first down for Hamlin. And that was Cody Naminga saving a touchdown.
Brady Buck and the rest of the Hamlin offensive line just putting a beautiful hole there for Grantham. There he goes, right side, right behind the blockers, shakes them off. He is off to the 25-yard line, first and 10 for the Hamlin Chargers, trailing by 8.
First down, Chargers on the march. Grantham throws another long ball, high arcing pass. He's got a man. It's caught. Touchdown, Hamlin. Neiman with the catch.
Austin Neiman having to run under the football. It got hung up a little bit. He's able to grab it. Dives into the end zone with an Avon player around him, and it is 8-6. There's the pass. Now here comes Neiman. Waiting. Got it. Puts up a nice catch. And the Pirates try to stop him, but he gets into the end zone, breaks the plane before he hits the ground. And the Chargers will try to tie up the football game.
They'll go for two. Two backs with Grantham. Quarterback run, he's got a lane. We're tied at 8.
Very nice run for 2 points for Grantham. He took the snap, went toward the left side, and got plenty of help to get over there and get the two-point conversion. This is going to be a good one. I can feel it already.
Check out, watch the blocking there, and Grantham with the speed managed to just outrace the defense, get into the end zone for that two-point conversion. 6 plays, 84 yards, 118 time of possession on that scoring drive by the Hamlin Chargers.
So the two teams kind of mirroring each other on their touchdown drives. Went about 84 yards that time for the drive, ending up with the very nice catch for the touchdown coming from Austin Neiman.
Hey, don't forget, next week it'll be the girls state volleyball tournaments. We'll have coverage online at sdpb.org beginning on Thursday the 21st. It all leads up to our coverage on Saturday night on all three public television channels of all three tournaments. They're in different locations this year. Right. Class A will be on SDPB1, Class B will be on SDPB2, and Class AA will be on SDPB3. Again, that's 6 Central, 5 Mountain time next Saturday night, the 23rd, the third place, then the championship matches as the ladies get center stage next week.
And that is really a great move by the High School Activities Association to put each class in a different community. You're helping with the economics of those communities, and you kind of get teams in a little more of a spotlight as well, and it's a tribute to the growth of high school volleyball in South Dakota, too, as they moved to the fall season just a few years ago.
Yep, back in, I think, 2002, they switched seasons with basketball and volleyball switching places. A squib kick is going to roll out of bounds.
That will be an illegal procedure penalty that goes against the Hamlin Chargers. They have tried squib kicks, the first one pretty successful, and that's not an easy thing to do, to get that to bounce along the turf the right way and try to provide a little bit of disruption maybe for the return man, but it never got to the return man. It goes out of bounds at the 35, and that's where the Pirates will take it, tied at 8 with Hamlin.
Yep,
but the clock's moving, and I'm not sure it should be, should it?
Yeah, the clock is moving here, and it should not be. I don't know if the officials see it. They'll put it in play. Well, now they'll stop it for the moment. We'll have to see how this plays out. Straight up the middle, penalty flag is down on the run by the fullback for Avon.
Umpire
Anderson.
Right into the pile. Anderson was trying to get some yards up the middle, and the penalty will be, as you see, on the Pirates.
So that'll back them up 10 from the spot of the infraction, which is about a yard beyond the line of scrimmage.
Holding, white, 10-yard penalty, repeat first down.
Holding call right in the scrum going against the Pirates. They will get first down again, but they're going to have a first and about 20-yard situation. First and 19. Well, now back to first and 20. Yep, the stick moves to the 25. First and 20 from the 25-yard line for Avon.
Avon has two running backs averaging over 10 yards per carry coming into this game. And here's the option. Mutter keeps it, cuts up the middle, gets maybe two.
Just nothing there for him. Alex Holdsworth helping out on the tackle. Kristen Leeseth off there as well. A nice job not being faked on the option. They come right side, pull it into the belly of the running back, and just nowhere to go. Namkin and some others on the tackle. Namkin, Grantham, and of course Alex Holdsworth. It is second down, 18 for Avon.
Wishbone set. Second man through Kutchmick to the right side. Crashes up the middle. Gets across the 30 to the 34-yard line.
Hamlin's defense not fooled again. Once again, the tackle going to Holdsworth as they tried to send the very fleet of foot Kutchmick off the right side. And Hamlin was there waiting, ready for it, and stopped it. It'll be third down and 11 to go for the Pirates from Avon's 34.
Big opportunity here for the Charger defense to make a stand and force another Avon punt. Of course, Kutchmick had a dandy this first time around. But Hamlin's got to take care of some business here first and stop the Pirates on third down if they can. Long count, and I think we got a delay of game.
That
and
will be the call against Avon, and you can look at the
play
official.
White, 5-yard penalty.
Umpire counts down the last few seconds, and you have to get the ball snapped by there. Now, Hamlin is on the business end of the third and 15, and really can't afford to let Avon off the deck here.
Nope, this is an opportunity for the Charger defense against a team that doesn't throw the ball a lot. Second man through, Kutchmick tries to get to the sideline. He's going to be corralled and knocked out of bounds at the 35-yard line.
Kristen Namkin helping out on the tackle. Ryder Grantham as well. It'll be fourth down and a bunch, and we will see the apparent Kutchmick punt.
Kutchmick tried to cut it to the outside, and there was an opening there, but the Hamlin defense was able to corral him, not let him get to the sideline. Dropping back, that is Tristan Namkin to there to receive the punt. Kutchmick stands at his own 24. Not much pressure, and the lefty gets it away. Another good punt. It's going to take a good Avon bounce, and once again, Namkin has to let it roll, and it'll die inside the 20. Line drive punts, for the most part, by Kutchmick, but he's gotten good bounce, and they've been difficult bounces for the return man to handle.
He doesn't appear to have a lot of hang time on his kicks. He just kicks it deep, and by the time you figured out the bounce, the team's down there anyway.
So they'll put it back all the way to the 17-yard line. That's where Brody Grantham and the Charger offense will set up with 2:10 left to go first quarter. We're tied at 8. Again, two receivers split out to the right, one out to the left. Quarum gets the direct snap. They've done this on almost every first down, but Quarum can get across the 20 to the 24. Still a good gain on first down.
They really like that direct snap play, don't they? I mean, you figure for the most part that the quarterback Grantham is going to get it, but they'll give it to somebody in the backfield. Your center really has to be alert and versatile back there and be pretty good, fairly good long snap.
That's not an easy snap to make.
No. And then you have to get up and block the guy in front of you, which makes it tougher still because you know you're going to get beat on it.
Second down, about 3 yards to go. Grantham on the keeper, tries the left side. He'll be a couple of yards shy of the first down marker, cut down at the 25.
That hole was open on the right side, and Jacob Knodel was able to grab the leg of the ball carrier and bring it down. Third down and a couple to go as the Chargers look at the situation. You'd have to think they're probably not going to try to throw here.
No, both teams rely on their running game. Hamlin only averages 52 yards passing a game. They have thrown the ball, and they've thrown it deep. But Grantham on the keeper, he'll get the first down across the 30. Penalty flags all over the place.
One came from the sideline and another from behind the play at about the 40-yard line. And they'll confer with the officials, taking their time and make sure that penalties are figured out. Face mask will be the call on Avon.
And I believe this is the inadvertent face mask. Let's check it out. Yep, there you see it right there.
Just kind of got hung up in
face
it.
Face mask, white, 15-yard penalty, end of the run, first down.
And they're going to give him the big one instead of the inadvertent. They're going to give him the personal foul one. That's 15 yards added on to the end of the run. First down, Hamlin.
And there are two. Mike Hendrickson explained this really well last night in the 11A game. If it's an inadvertent, you just touch the face mask or something, that'll be the 5-yard penalty. If you get a hold of it and you hold on, that turns into the personal foul in the 15-yard.
So Hamlin, they have it first and 10 at the 45-yard line. They'll put a man in motion, that's Neiman, quarterback keeper. Up the middle. Not much there. Well, check that was Quarum on that direct snap again.
Right, and they get it to Quarum. You know, one of the things that series does is it keeps the defense honest. You anticipate it'll go to the quarterback, but it could go to any one of two or three guys back there, so you really don't know how to align yourself.
And that time they brought the other wide receiver slash running back, Neiman, in motion. Brought him in as an extra blocker coming in from the right side of the formation. Second down.
Could be the last play of the quarter.
And five. Quick moving first quarter here. And we are done with quarter number one. Hamlin 8, Avon 8. This is the 9B championship football game on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Getting ready for the second quarter here of this 9B championship football game. Avon and Hamlin tied up at 8. I'm Steve Toom along with Gary Ellenbolt and Mike Hendrickson. Kind of what we expected, a lot of running for both teams.
A lot of running and a hard-fought close game. We expected that as well through the game with both teams being unbeaten on the season. Hamlin's first appearance as a nine-man school, last made the Dome in 1999, losing in the 11A championship to Vermillion 21-14.
And we got a false start.
That will be the first penalty on Hamlin for the game. That'll go back to second and 10. Put it back to the 45-yard line.
This is the first of three games today here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. We got some stats updates.
Three first downs for the Pirates, 13 carries for 101 yards, nothing through the air. As far as the Chargers, 10 carries, 81 yards, 25 passing yards, 1 out of 3 for passing.
Direct snap, Quarum up the middle. He'll get about 3 yards. Total yards, boy, pretty even after one period. Hamlin with 106, Avon with 101. Time of possession, Avon 7.5 minutes, Hamlin 2.5 minutes. That's kind of typical for Avon.
They will use
up the clock. Yeah, just moving the ball down the field.
If you're good with a ball control offense, you've got a great shot because you only really need to score once as long as you keep moving because the opponent can't do a thing with it.
Third down and 7 for Hamlin. They'll throw, and it's in and out of the hands of Namkin. Incomplete, the little slant pattern to the middle of the field.
It was there. Namkin had the opening, had the defender beaten. Couldn't hang on to the pass, and the Chargers will go to 4th and 7. Drive stalls at their 48-yard line, and the Chargers will kick it away.
Yeah, that pass was right on target. Amkin just couldn't haul it in as Kutzmick drops back deep. 3rd in the state last year in the 400. As there a little bit of pressure applied, but a good punt is away. Kutzmick collects it inside his 20. Looks for a block. Penalty flags down, and Kutzmick just needs to hold on to the football. So we have a block in the back that's going to be against Avon. We have an injured Charger on the field. Getting up slowly was Brady Buck, number 35.
Buck has had some good tackles. He is up and walking on his own, but, seems to be favoring himself. getting, it looks like he'll stay in the game at least, which is good.
He's going to try to walk it off here. It is a block in the back against the Pirates, so that'll back up Avon.
Block in the back. White, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Mike Chilson, our referee.
Crew from the Chamberlain area. If you're watching online, first of all, thank you. Secondly, Chamberlain, right where East River and West River come together, and you'll see the difference as soon as you hit Olacoma.
And we send out, again, a big hello to everyone watching wherever you may be online at sdpb.org.
And let us know where you're watching online, because we'd like to see where you're coming from today.
Handoff. That's Tolsma. Second man through. Tries to bounce it to the outside and won't get a whole lot here. Maybe it'll depend on the spot here as they disappear from our view on the near sideline.
Could have lost yardage there, but Tolsma able to bounce off a couple of Hamlin defenders. Couldn't get around the third one. Here he comes, left side, holes closed, tries to get the sideline. There's one, and then gets wrestled out of bounds by one of the Chargers. It'll be second down, 8 to go.
Yep, only a 2-yard gain on the play. Avon will not change their offensive look. Line up with those three running backs. Kutzmick cut down in the backfield. He will lose yardage back to the original line of scrimmage.
Quick handoff went to Kutzmick. Nothing doing as the Chargers were able to come up with the big tackle on second down. Now it goes to third down. And they've got about eight, maybe nine to go as they lose a yard. Great play by the Hamlin defense, and we have known all year that this is a very good Charger defense, and they've been as advertised to this point.
Third down and 9. The option play. Kutzmick hit in the backfield, drop for a loss. Neiman with the big tackle for the Chargers.
Austin Neiman knew exactly what was coming as they ran option right side. Kutzmick with no opportunity to do anything. There's the pitch, and as soon as the pitch happened, there was Austin Neiman with the grab, with the tackle. It's fourth down and a bunch, and Kutzmick will kick the football away.
Yeah, and he'll stand in his own end zone. Namkin back deep. High snap, not much pressure brought. A little bit off the side of his foot, but they'll take a decent Avon bounce. Now angles to the sideline right at the 40-yard line, and it will be Charger football right there, first and 10. Don't forget, you can follow SDPB Sports on your mobile device all season long. We're providing frequent updates to all South Dakota High School Championship events on Facebook and Twitter, so make sure you search SDPB Sports and hook up with us.
First down and 10, Chargers in very good field position. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter with the at sign, then SDPB Sports.
Football this weekend, volleyball next weekend. See if they do that direct snap. No, this time actually Grantham's going to get it. He's got a big hole to the 30, fighting off tacklers across the 25. A big gain for Hamlin.
That was a beautiful hole on the right side. Grantham took the snap and went right side, got through the hole, dodged a couple of tacklers, and picked up another 3 or 4 yards for his trouble there. Corralled the high snap. Look at that hole. Just a thing of beauty. Gets around Kutzmick, then Kutzmick has to get around one of his own players, slows him down enough to make the stop. Big first down for Hamlin, the Chargers at the 23, first and 10.
Yeah, Logan Mutter assisting on that tackle. First and 10, Chargers, and we've got a whistle. Flag is down.
Another false start. That'll be the second false start of the football game for the Chargers. They'll move back 5 yards, go to first and 15.
False start, move. Repeat first down.
Don't forget, complete stats and information about all South Dakota High School Athletic Championships can be found online. Log on to sdpb.org for complete coverage. First and 15, Chargers. Again to the right side, Grantham's got an opening to the 15 and out of bounds. It'll be near the first down marker.
Tolsma making the tackle, had to come basically from the middle of the field over, which gave Grantham plenty of room to get a nice run going. gets away with the stiff arm from one tackler. Here comes Grantham, and he makes the stop, but a beautiful run by the quarterback Grantham. And again, Tolsma with the tackle.
First down. They're going to put it down right at the 10-yard line, so this is first and goal to go for Hamlin. An impressive drive going right now by the Chargers. Avon digging in defensively. Out of the shotgun. Direct snap, Quarum. He can go nowhere. Left side shut down by the Pirate defense.
Looked like he had the opening on the left side, but wasn't able to get around there. Namiga is able to make the tackle. Alex Bolvin also on the stop. It'll go to second and goal for the Chargers. Technically no gain. Second and goal from the 10.
Tolsma averaging over 14 tackles a game. And he has on the year an incredible 16 and a half tackles for loss. That is an impressive number for number 26 for the Pirates. Wants to throw over the middle. It is caught. And it is a touchdown for Hamlin.
Grantham coming up with the step. Grantham to Grantham as Ryder Grantham comes up with the diving grab in the end zone. And the Chargers have their first lead. It is 14-8 on the catch, the dive, the score. Chargers will go for the PAT.
And for Ryder Grantham, that is his first touchdown catch of the year. He only had three catches on the season coming into the game, and a little slant pattern gets him into the end zone for Hamlin. Now, Chargers will line up for two. Brody Grantham rolls out to his right, being pursued, throws over the middle, and that is incomplete.
Hit the ground before it got to the receiver, and an incomplete pass, two-point conversion not good, and an injured, this is Buck once again for Hamlin, injured player.
Yeah, Brady Buck, number 35, check it out on the replay. Good pressure applied by Avon. Pass just a little short. Yep, oh, hit the turf, yep. No doubt about it.
If he got his hands under it and hauled it in, it's good, but he couldn't quite get that to happen. And Buck, again, the injured Charger.
Brady is a 5'10", 177-pound senior. Plays on the offensive line and plays linebacker as well. Let's hope the young man's okay. They're checking out his leg. Hopefully it's nothing more serious than a leg cramp.
And he had had some issues earlier in the half with those and was limping a little bit. Looks like they're trying to take care. Might have hyperextended something. And, yeah,
you just don't know. The last person
in the world to speculate. But we will check on the injury to Buck. We get a word, we'll pass it along.
Don't forget, coming up here on Sunday afternoon, a great program. It's the premiere of the Gettysburg Story. 150 years, America's greatest battle is recounted as you've never seen it before. The Gettysburg Story provides a unique bird's eye view of the Gettysburg National Military Park. That'll be on Sunday afternoon at 3 Central, 2 Mountain Time. Stephen Lang narrates that fantastic program.
There are people who say they go to Gettysburg and other battlefields, and it's almost like you can smell the smoke from the battles. Mm-hmm. When you go there, and you just, it's such a vivid, imaginative thing to do. And you know, if it's on our airwaves, it's going to be an outstanding piece of TV programming.
Yeah.
Okay.
Check out, this is the touchdown here. And I was wondering,
look at the reception. Look how low he got, almost like that right knee is on the turf, which would make the ball dead right there at the 3-yard line.
I was wondering that when that play happened. Good job on the replay, guys,
because
that happened so very quickly. But, yeah, when the knee goes down, it doesn't matter if you've been touched by a defender or not in the high school ranks. You're supposed to be down, but Hamlin gets the touchdown. They're up 14-8 as their two-point conversion attempt was no good. Still a lot of time left until halftime.
Greta Grantham going to kick the football away, and there it goes.
Squib kick. Uh-oh, is touched by one of the upmen and cuts. McWisely falls on it at the 30-yard line for the Pirates.
The upman had a chance to grab it and go. It went past him. Looked like he deflected it just a bit, but Kutzmick was able to come up with it. That is a live ball as soon as it's kicked, if it goes 10 yards.
It's got to go the 10 yards, and then it's anybody's football. Pirates on offense. They scored on their first drive. They haven't done much since. They've only got 98 yards of offense on the all on the ground. 155 yards of offense for Hamlin. Their offense is firing a little better here. Option, Mutter keeps it. Got about 2, maybe 3 yards on the gain for Avon.
So the Pirates will pick up about 2 or 3 yards. That'll be a second and 7 situation for Avon, again in the southern part of the state. They will routinely play teams like Andy Central every once in a while, head up to the Centerville area.
And they'll play some tough teams out of conference as well. They play in a pretty tough football conference. And here comes Tolsma, student body left. He gets to the 40, cuts it back, out of bounds. Should be enough for a first down, and it is for Avon.
Nice run by Tolsma as he sweeps to the left side. Had plenty of blockers around. You see Kutzmer there, trying to find somebody to hit. He finds someone to hit. Watch this hurdle. That is it. Had to hurdle his own guy and then stepped out of bounds right there at the 45-yard line.
Yep, it'll be a first down for the Pirates. Stops the clock with 7:07 left, quarter number 2. This time it's Kutzmann. Finds a little seam close quickly by the Hamlin defense. Got about 2 yards or so on the play.
With a couple of exceptions, Hamlin's defense has done a very nice job against that sweep and that option. Especially when they go toward the far side, toward the right. The defenders for the Chargers seem to be able to pick that up right away and prevent the corner.
And that's what you have to do against Avon. When you got speedy backs like Kutzmick and Tolsma, you have to be able to shut off the sideline. You cannot let those guys turn the corner, otherwise they're gone. Second down and about 8. This time it's Tolsma, runs into one of his own blockers and maybe got 2 yards on the play.
Tolsma hit and driven backwards as soon as he got that couple of yards, but it'll be a 3rd and 5, a situation that Avon has faced a few times before on this Friday morning slash afternoon, not quite to the afternoon yet, in either time zone in South Dakota. 6-minute mark, we're halfway through the second quarter, and Hamlin has the lead at 14-8.
Big third down and about 6 coming up. Option, Mutter crashes forward. He should have the first down.
Going to be a very close play. He needed to get to the 44.5 roughly to get there.
Yeah, I think he's
going to be very close, and they gave it to him. No measurement needed. Move the sticks. First down and 10 for Avon.
Yep. Fake the fullback dive. Mutter just keeps it. Goes around the left side. Got more than enough for the first down.
He really does a nice job with the fakes, too, as he gets it right into the belly of the guy going up on the dive and then keeps the ball and catches Hamlin or any defense a little bit flat-footed.
First and 10 Pirates. This time it's Kutzmick. Just can't get through the hole before it closes. Hamlin cuts him down after about a gain of 1.5 yards.
Ryder Grantham on the tackle for the Chargers. Grantham with a touchdown earlier in the quarter. Gain of 2 for Kutzmick. And the Pirates, who have 126 yards on the ground or total offense, and then 120 yards on the ground for Hamlin with 35 passing yards, total of 155.
Second out, we'll call it 8 from the 42. This time it's Tolsma, wants to get outside. He got a little bit of a hole. Nice hard running by Devin Tolsma. Gets him close to the first down marker.
And he got hung up in one of the blockers. In fact, he ran into the back of Josh Knodel as they were moving to that left side. And no opportunity really for Hamlin to recover from that. In any case, there's the run in. He keeps moving, keeps going forward, and gets the first down for the effort.
Yep, first and 10 Pirates. Ball in between the 33 and 34-yard line as they move from right to left. Misdirection play. This time it's Anderson, the fullback, and he'll get about a couple of yards.
Anderson seems to be a really good short yardage back. And fullbacks, basically, if they're not just blocking backs, in your particular scheme are good for about 2 or 3 or 4 yards, maybe more every once in a while, but you don't expect, just the nature of the beast, you don't expect a lot from them as far as yardage goes.
Anderson, a sophomore. Tolsma, a junior. Cole Beeson, who has gotten time, he's a junior. Mutter, the quarterback, a junior. Kutzmick, a senior. Handoff up the middle. Hard running by Tolsma. Refuses to go down. He'll get to the 26-yard line. And across that front wall, Josh Canodal, a junior. Reeves is a senior. Balvin, a sophomore. Jacob Canodal, a junior. Lucas, a senior. And Naminga, they switch in and out on the plays. Naminga coming in now. He's a junior. So this Avon team, pretty set for the future. Of course, they got business to take care of right now.
Right. We've heard on a few occasions and said on a few occasions how quick Tolsma is. He really showed his quickness and his strength on that last play.
Third down and about 3. Mutter taking his time. Kutzmick gets caught up. He's brought down shy of the marker, but this is 4-down territory, one would think, for Coach Culver and his Pirate crew.
And very few times at this level are field goals attempted, and that would be in the neighborhood of about 41 yards. Not sure what Avon's situation is with that, but at 4th and very short and trailing, you might as well give it a shot.
When you got the 1-2 punch of Kutzmick and Tolsma, 4th down and less than a yard to go, one would think you're going to go for it. The Pirates are from the 24. Quarterback keeper. And this will be close. Depends on the spot. And they may have to bring out the chain gang from the sideline. Boy, this one's gonna be close, but he may have, I think he's got it.
I do too.
Maybe half the length of the football, if that.
Mm-hmm.
Clock stops, 2:30 left. A good drive going by the Pirates.
We have a minute to share some trivia.
Yeah, we do.
Garney Henley is a fellow who played at Hayti High School, had an outstanding career at Huron College, and also played professional football in Canada. Was drafted by the Green Bay Packers, chose to play in Canada.
We got a change of possession. They didn't make it. We're going to step aside for a moment. This is the Class 9B Championship football game on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
TV timeout.
Charger defense just came up with a big stand on 4th and short. Hamlin gets it back. They're up by 6, 2:30 left. Second quarter of this 9B championship football game. I'm Steve Toome along with Gary Ellenbolt and Mike Henriksen. Craig Maddock will be joining us later on today.
The Hamlin Chargers 77 yards away and 2 minutes and 30 seconds to play with here in the first half. Time to see how much of a motivator stopping the Pirates on 4th and short is.
Hamlin with all 3 timeouts. Direct snap, Quarum tries the left side. He's got an opening down the sideline. Across midfield. First down, Chargers.
And it looked for a second like Kutzmick was not going to have a chance to get the ball carrier, but he was able to get himself away from one of the Charger blockers and make the stop. Otherwise, who knows what happens. There's the nice run, left side. Kutzmick with the recovery, and then finally makes the stop. 1st and 10, Chargers at the Avon 45.
Big run there because clock winding down against the Chargers. We got a false start once again.
That'll be the 3rd false start penalty. Note this, ball, Hamlin has...
False start, 5-yard penalty.
Hamlin has all 3 of its timeouts. Avon called 1 in the half. 2 minutes and 6 to go.
So back up the Chargers 5 yards. A team that can throw the football. Again, both teams like to run. Not too much of a time crunch yet with 2:05 and counting. The Chargers with 3 timeouts in their pocket. 1st and 15. Direct snap, Quarum again. He'll push the pile forward. Only got about 4 yards on the play.
Quarum getting a bit of a breather after the false start penalty after that long run. He's able to pick up 4 yards and mitigate a bit of the damage, but a long way to go and a fairly short time to get there for the Chargers with a minute 32 and 46 yards away from the end zone.
Important for Avon defensively not to give up a score here in the waning moments of the second period. Hamlin will get the ball to start the third period. Another false start. This one against Hamlin.
And Jeff Sheehan has really got to be talking to himself.
False start, 5 yards.
On that Hamlin sideline. Well, there he is. Jeff Sheehan exhorting the troops a little bit. Not happy at all with two false start penalties on this drive and 4 for the game.
Time winding down.
Ryder Grantham coming back into the contest.
Clock has stopped with a minute 14 after the penalty, and now it'll be put in motion again.
Again, the Chargers have all 3 of their timeouts. They have not elected to use one just yet.
Second and long. Grantham stands, throws, got a man, it's open, it's caught! First down.
Right over the shoulders of Ryder Grantham. Comes up with a nice catch, hits him in full stride, does Brody Grantham, and Ryder Grantham gets to the 11-yard line, first down.
Check it out on the replay, has time, steps into the throw.
Nice pass.
Oh, perfectly thrown. Beat the defender, that was Cody Naminga, who ends up making the tackle, but now Hamlin in great position about the 11-yard line. Grantham breaks into the open. He'll have one man to beat. Touchdown, Hamlin Chargers.
He was leveled on the play by Cole Beeson and able to just bounce off number 30 and go into the end zone, but he took a hard and serious licking, but he got in. Touchdown, Hamlin. It is 20-8.
And watch when he gets past the original line. Right there, he gets past Kutzmick. It is wide open. Beeson tried to stop him.
Not another thing Beeson was going to be able to do.
No, really, really couldn't do much more than that. And now the Chargers up 20-8. They'll go for 2. As Avon will make a substitution here. They bring in Anderson. He'll line up at a defensive back. And Hamlin going for 2. They'll put a man in motion. That's Neiman. Double back set. Grantham to the outside, and he gets into the end zone. It's a 2-point conversion.
What a beautiful play call. They bunched up the running backs to either side of Grantham in kind of a tight set in the backfield. Avon anticipating something up the middle, but no such luck as Brody Grantham took the snap, rolled left side, wide open into the end zone, makes it a 22-8 ball game.
Open space on the left side, and Brody Grantham easily into the end zone. It's a 14-point edge for the Chargers. 4 plays, 76 yards, 1:49 time of possession, and by not using the timeouts, it ends up helping Hamlin, because now Avon has only got 41 seconds to work with. They're a team that, again, their big plays come out of their running game, but they haven't had a whole lot of big plays lately.
How big is that fourth down stop by the Charger defense now? Because that is what gave Hamlin the ball and led to the touchdown.
Yeah, Avon was driving for a score that would have at least tied the game. You see the scoring drive recap. That fourth down stand was huge for Hamlin. And remember, Hamlin gets the football to start period number 3.
2 big plays on that drive. Certainly the run by Quirum that put them into Avon territory. And then the long pass downfield that went to Ryder Grantham that had the ball on the 11 or 12. And they score after that.
Yeah, and Hamlin had a couple of penalties, you know, that a couple false starts there. And they look like, well, maybe the drive will stall at midfield, give Avon maybe one more crack, but then the big pass play really opened things up for the Chargers, and then a play later, they're into the end zone. Brody Grantham getting ready to kick off. Kutzmick stands around his own 22, expecting a squib kick, and it's a line drive, and it's going to roll out of bounds.
Kind of the chances you take with the squib kick is it takes some crazy bounces all over the place. That one bouncing to the left of the left hash mark from Grantham's perspective. And it bounced out. Illegal procedure is the penalty. Avon gets the ball with two timeouts and 40 seconds left. They'll take it at the 35-yard line.
And again, Avon, a team not known for throwing the football. If they have
take the ball on the 35-yard line.
If they have a big play, it's probably going to try to get it into the hands of Kutzmick or Tolsma, try to get them to the outside, try to get them to where they can operate in space. So Avon, 41 seconds left and two timeouts. They need a big play. They'll try Tolsma. They scored on this play before. Tolsma pulled down at the 41-yard line. Nice gain on the play. Just couldn't quite get out in the open.
Brody Grantham able to make the stop as he came off the right side. Tolsma, a good runner and incredibly strong runner as well in addition to speed. It'll be a 6-yard gain for the Pirates. Avon now at second down and four.
Clock running, 15 seconds left. Option play, Mutter pitches, it's bobbled and knocked backwards. And who's got it? Near the sideline, it may have gone out of bounds.
That was Tristan Namkin who got his hand on the ball on the pitch. He had the option played pretty well defensively for the Chargers. And just before it got to Kutzmer, he was able to get the big hand up there. Here comes the pitch. Look at that. Just batted it right away for the guy. Incredible presence of mind to do that. It goes rolling back. Kutzmick able to come up with the save, but barely.
Just a couple seconds left. Avon's going to take a knee, and we are done with one half of football. It started out strong for Avon. They drove down the field on their first possession. They got a touchdown and a two-point conversion, but Hamlin came back. They put up three touchdowns, 22 unanswered points for the Hamlin Chargers. And they lead here at the intermission, 22-8 for Grantham. He has now 28 combined touchdowns on the year, 1,261 yards rushing, 16 TDs. On the ground for that young man, number 10, for the Hamlin Chargers.
And momentarily, we'll visit with Mike Hendrickson, who will have a visit with Jeff Sheehan, the head coach of the Hamlin Chargers. He and his coaches in a traditional post-half huddle, talking over some things they want to discuss with the team. And momentarily, as you hear the shouts of the Charger faithful, here is Mike Hendrickson to visit with head coach Jeff Sheehan of the Chargers.
All right, we are here with Jeff Sheehan. And coach, listen, everybody talked about 4,000-yard rushers in this game. Your defense played terrific that first half.
Yeah, we started out a little slow on the first drive. They let them go down the field and get 80 yards on that first drive. A few miscues that we worked on all the week, but they bounced back really well. And we played a very good rest of the half, didn't give up any points. You know, and our defense dug their heels in. It was a bend and don't break mentality, and they did that.
The offense has obviously been working all year, too. What adjustments, plans did you make for taking on Avon, who's also been very solid defensively?
We just figured we had to block fundamentals. I mean, that's all it is get to the place, and we go fundamentally and, you know, block and take advantage of a little misdirection here and there, and that's what's happened, and we got some big running lanes, and, you know, the kids have been playing very well and sticking with their blocks, which is encouraging.
All right, thanks, Coach. Best of luck, second half.
Thank you very much.
You bet. Jeff Sheehan joining us here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. They are on top, 22-8. We're back to take a look at some stats, some highlights, and a lot more. Thanks so much for joining us on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
We are at halftime of the 9B championship football game. Hamlin 22, Avon 8. That's our score. The first of three games today here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. We got an award presentation to make. Let's turn it over now to Mr. Greg Merrigan, our public address announcer.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? This afternoon, the South Dakota Sports Officials Advisory Council is proud to present its 25-year officiating award. This award is presented to recognize officials in all sports for their contributions over a period of 25 years. Presenting the award is Buck Timmons, representing the South Dakota Sports Officials Advisory Council. Tonight's 25-year officiating award recipient is Quint Garnos of Presho. Quint began officiating in 1987. He has worked 2 9B championships during his career. Quint participated in football as an athlete and an official. Quint feels it's important to give back to the game and the student athletes. Ladies and gentlemen, Quint Garnos.
And congratulations to Quint Garnos. We'll have more coming up here from the Dakota Dome in just a moment. You're watching the Class 9B Championship football game on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Championship event is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, by SDN Communications, and by the Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota.
This is the Dakota Dome in Vermilion, Class 9B Championship football game, the first of three today on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Hamlin with a 22-8 advantage here at the intermission, and here are our team stats.
First downs, the Chargers lead it 11-6. They have 168 rushing yards, 73 through the air. Grand total of 241 yards. Time of possession favoring Avon, which would stand to reason, by 14:59 to 9:01. As far as the Pirates, 6 first downs, 131 yards on the ground, none through the air. Again, it's Avon. 131 total yards and no turnovers by either team. Hamlin really in good shape in the fact that they're playing a predominantly running team, putting them in a position where eventually they're going to have to throw the football.
Here's Tolsma on a big run, and he'll get to the end zone early on. First drive of the game for the Avon Pirates. They marched all the way downfield. 7 plays, 79 yards, 244, but back comes Hamlin. A high arcing pass, Grantham to Neiman. That was good.
Neiman with the grab, diving into the end zone with one of the Avon players right on top of him. He got it done.
And here was another pass. This one, Brody Grantham to Ryder Grantham from 10 yards out. And another big run by Brody Grantham here with just a couple minutes left to go. It's capped off a 4-play, 76-yard drive. Took a minute 49 time of possession, and Hamlin with the advantage here. It started off a strong effort by Avon, but their offense has been bottled up a bit here in the last, from the pretty much the halfway mark of the first quarter on, and then that big fourth down stand deep in Hamlin territory really turned things around, and then Hamlin getting points out of it.
And Jeff Sheehan was right. They did get off to kind of a slow start on the first couple of possessions, but they were able to get that done. One thing that definitely is a cause for concern, the 4 false start penalties on the part of the Chargers in the half. They weren't hurt an awful lot. They've got the 22-8 lead, certainly, but it's a difficult situation and something that they'll try to make a correction for and adjustment to at the half.
Kutzmick was 65 yards on the ground on 11 carries. Tolsma was 65 yards on 10 carries. Meanwhile, for Hamlin, Grantham has 103 yards on 8 carries, including a 24-yarder. And Grantham is 3 of 6 passing for 73 yards, so he's accounted for most of the Hamlin offense. Let's take a timeout and come back with more. You're watching the Class 9B Championship football game on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
And welcome back to the Dakota Dome in Vermilion at halftime. The Chargers on top of the Pirates, 22-8. We're with the head coach of the Avon Pirates, Tom Culver. Listen, Tom, adjustments at halftime.
Well, I think we're big thing is we got to stay with our blocks offensively. We've getting to the right guys. We're just not staying with them, and that's one thing we discussed in there. And then, you know, defensively, we got to be a little more physical. We got to be better tacklers. So we've had opportunities to make plays and just haven't done it.
Did anything that they do in that first half surprise you at all?
No, it's stuff we've seen all year long. It's stuff we were expecting them to do. You know, that's their bread and butter, and like ours is. And so we're just going to have to see if we can adjust and make a little comeback here.
All right, Tom, best of luck second half. Thanks for the time.
All right, thank you.
You bet. Tom Culver, the head coach of the Avon Pirates. Again, they trail 22-8. They have not trailed at halftime all season long. They were barely ahead of Gregory early in the year, but they have not trailed. So this is new territory for the Avon Pirates. Let's send it back up to the booth with Steve Toome and Gary Ellenbold.
All right, Mike, thank you very much. And something to note here for Hamlin, one of their linemen, number 35, Brady Buck, obviously will not return. He's on the sideline in crutches. The pads and the uniform are off. So it appears that his day is done. And we'll see how that affects the Hamlin lineup. He's one of their key players on the offensive line and a linebacker.
And you see him there along the sideline on the crutches trying to rally his blue and gold Charger troops into the second half. Hamlin will have the ball to start half number two. And in good shape because Avon is a team that kind of has difficulty catching up at any run-oriented offense. Will have that problem. So be interesting to see if they try to go to the air or just what they will do to try to get back into the game.
Important for the Pirates to start off with a defensive stand here to start this third quarter, because the last thing Avon wants to do is fall down by three scores in this contest. That's kind of one of those areas, even for passing teams, even at the college level, at the high school level, and you can even say in the pros, you fall down by three scores, that's a pretty big hole
exactly
to climb out of.
And a wishbone team, by its nature, does have problems, you know, getting back into one, but they still have 24 minutes of game clock, and we've seen comebacks before.
Absolutely. Last night was a great comeback by West Central. They were down 21-7 to Madison, came back and won that game 28-21 with only about 20 seconds left on a halfback pass. A very exciting game last night here at the Dakota Dome.
We did find out, somebody mentioned to us that Garney Henley, the person we talked about in the first half, the former CFL and Huron College standout, still lives in Huron.
Wow.
And hopefully Mr. Henley, who had a great career at Hayti and at Huron College, and with the CFL, had a chance to play for the Green Bay Packers, was drafted in the 15th round in 1960, but decided to play north of the border. The way the Packers season is, I tend to get choked up, you know. When I'm
I think the Packers can maybe use him with all the injuries they've had. Boy, and just, you know, talk about injuries, you know, not to go too far in the NFL, but boy, this has been a year for injuries all around in the National Football League. Well, we're getting ready. The first of three, second half here, the first of three games today here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Coming up after the conclusion of this game, we'll take a quick break and then have Canton versus Parkston. And then the nightcap will be the 11AA championship match. That will be Watertown taking on the Peer Governors. And
two words on that. Shea Brantlin.
Shea Brantlin is a pretty good football player for the Watertown Arrows. Their main running back has that dangerous combination of size and speed. And then Saturday night, we will wrap things up with the 11AAA championship. That will be Lincoln versus Roosevelt. Two teams that played a 35-28 game, I believe, earlier this year. And throughout the season, it was kind of clear that those two teams were probably the best teams in the 11AAA ranks. Here we've got 9B football, still a half to go. Avon kicking off to Hamlin. Chargers up 22-8. Deep kickoff. And that's Neiman with the ball. He'll get close to the 30-yard line before he's brought down.
Started to return to the left side, and then he came back over the middle That's where he met the wall of Avon defenders. The Chargers have the ball, first and 10, 29-yard line, and have the lead here at 22-8 early in half two.
It's like Elix Rust, number 72, 6'2", 280-pound junior. He's in on the offensive line, replacing the injured Brady Buck. He'll be at the right guard spot for Hamlin. This is Grantham, simple quarterback keeper. Gets across the 30 near the 34-yard line.
Might be a little bit early to play the conservative kind of offense because you've got a lot of football to play, but as long as they can control the ball and keep moving things, it's a strategy that could very well work for them as the Pirates are down a couple of touchdowns.
Hamlin has mixed up the pass and the run, 73 yards through the air, 174 on the ground. Avon has all their yardage via the ground game. They haven't even attempted a pass. Direct snap, Quarum with the ball. Gets across the 35, pulled down at the 37-yard line.
Kutzmick able to make the tackle, and Tolsma helping him out as well. That time, the direct snap, they went to the right side. And picking up yardage, decent yardage, as the stick keeps moving. It'll be about a third and one situation for Hamlin. The Chargers with the ball at the Charger 38-yard line.
On all three of Hamlin's scoring possessions, all of them under 2 minutes as far as time of possession. So they've struck relatively quickly when they have scored. Two receivers out to the left, one out to the right. Quarterback draw here. And it'll be a first down for Hamlin.
Not a problem at all as they sent the ball to Brody Grantham. Just got behind the blockers, moved as far as he could, and as far as he had to, which wasn't very, picks up three on the play. 41-yard line is where the ball is spotted, and the Chargers keep it.
Both teams seeking their third perfect seasons. Hamlin did it in 91 and 96 and 11B. Avon did it in 2002 and 2005. Both teams seeking their fifth state title. All the previous ones for Hamlin as 11B. Direct snap, Quarum. He'll dive across the 45-yard line. I'd like to thank our friend Dan Gensler from SDSportsHistory.com, Mariah Press, for providing us some information here as he's going through the record books here at the Dome, crunching some numbers.
Isn't that a great service? And we learn things too, right along with the viewers, as they watch these championship games, and we find out a little bit about the history of the teams, and just an invaluable resource for us.
Second down, we'll call it five. 45-yard line. Here's a quarterback keeper, and Grantham into the open, slips a tackle. Flag is down. And so is Grantham across the 40 near the 38-yard line, but this one's probably going to be coming back.
And something in the backfield that will be a holding call that will go on the Pirates.
Check that on the Chargers.
Yes, Chargers, excuse me. And the Pirates will have the opportunity to tell the official
blue,
what they want.
Blue, 10-yard penalty, spot of the foul.
10-yard walk-off from the spot of the infraction here.
That's going to put things back at about the 35-yard line for Hamlin. And they'll have second and roughly 15. That was a nice run by Grantham, but somebody holding. And, you know, a lot of times that's the reason for the nice run.
Wipes out the great effort by Brody Grantham, who's accounted for most of the offense here today at halftime. He accounted for 176 of their 241 yards total offense. Worm the lone running back. Again, the quarterback keeper. And Grantham. Tolsma got to him first.
And Tolsma got to it barely because he was on the turf and was able to just get a hold of one of the legs of the quarterback, Grantham. He picks up a yard, maybe. You have to be in a really good mood or an optimist to give him that. Call a third down, a short 10.
Yeah, about 5 yard gain on the play as they're back to the original line of scrimmage. So third and 10 coming up for the Chargers, up 22-8. Big stand here for the Pirates. If they can make it, they need to get the ball back. Grantham will throw, and he will throw the ball as he's falling, and it's almost intercepted, and almost at the same time got to one of his receivers downfield. But that was a situation last night in Madison against West Central. Their quarterback threw a pass while he was falling down, and it got picked off.
Right, and here's the pass. He's going back to throw, just about wrapped up in the backfield. Somehow gets this football off as he's falling backward. There's the tip by Kutzmick, and not able to come up with it was Tristan Namkin.
And Hamlin has to spend a timeout here on a fourth down and 10 situation with 8:28 left to go, third period. In 1863, Abraham Lincoln proved himself a master of the new frontier with his high-tech command center, the War Department's telegraph office, America's first situation room. On the 150th anniversary of his famous Gettysburg Address, Lincoln at Gettysburg describes a major turning point in American history, the rebirth of a nation and the dawn of the information age. The program is called Lincoln at Gettysburg. It's Tuesday night at 8 Central, 7 Mountain Time on SDPB television.
Did you see that there's a paper, I believe, in the Gettysburg area that has apologized for panning the speech, the Gettysburg Address? Back in 1863.
Yeah, I remember in the Civil War documentary by Ken Burns, they quoted an article which was critical of President Lincoln's speech, and it's one of those, gosh, did we really say that kind of things now later, is Kutzmick gets the punt, return. He's down the sideline across midfield and pushed out of bounds near the 40. They'll have him out at the 39. A great return by Kutzmick.
Brody Grantham with the touchdown saving tackle. He also the punter. And Kutzmick had no doubt what he was going to do. He took the line drive punt well before the Hamlin defense got there. Rolls left side, has all kind of room. Grantham able to make the stop. That is how a team like Avon gets back into a game with a big special teams play.
That sets up the Pirates with great field position, first and 10 at the Hamlin 39. Big opportunity here for Avon. Let's see if they can capitalize. Tolsma has an opening, gets to the sideline. Down the sideline he goes. Touchdown, Avon Pirates, but hold on, there's a penalty flag.
Flag about 3 yards from the start of the run. No indication just yet, but it could very well be a hold, and it may be coming back as the Pirates are dejectedly walking backwards saying, I think it's on us. Here's the call.
Take the touchdown off the board. It will not count. Heartbreak City for Avon.
Indeed.
Holding, White, 10-yard penalty. Spot of the foul. Repeat first down.
So they get the first down back, but it's going to be, you know, of small comfort when they had a touchdown that really would have put them back into this ball game, at least from a momentum standpoint, but just not able to get it done without the penalty. It will be first down and about 17 to go. They need to get to the Charger 29 for the first down.
They're still in Hamlin territory. Beeson checks into the game at fullback. They're going to try a halfback pass. Kutzmick throws. He's got a man. It's caught. 15, first pass of the game for Avon is by their halfback.
One of those things you never see coming from an Avon team. Hamlin fully expecting the run, and they do the halfback option. Kutzmick with a great pass.
Pretty spiral.
Oh, wasn't that nice? And he comes up, hits the receiver, and coming up with the stop was Quirum.
That's only the second catch of the year for Cody Naminga. He had a 64-yard touchdown pass earlier in the year. Tolsma tries to bounce it outside, cuts up the middle. Hard running by Devin Tolsma gets him inside the 10.
Ryder Grantham slowing down Tolsma enough for the rest of the defense to catch up, but he does get a nice run in the process. That'll be a gain of about 7 yards. Avon really moving the football well and shaking off the holding call.
Yep, as the Pirates have it, second down and a long three. Here comes Kutzmick. Got a lane. He's in the end zone. Touchdown, Avon Pirates.
Nothing to it for Kutzmick as he rolls around the right side. Blockers did their job. Kutzmick did his. It's a 22-14 ball game. And here's the run from Kutzmick.
Watch the hole that opens up. My goodness. Not even touch. Brandon Kutzmick. Touchdown, Pirates. And now the all-important two-point conversion because Avon's still down by 8. They'll try Kutzmick around the right side, and he will get there, and it's a 6-point game.
Big PAT there, a big conversion. They basically ran Kutzmick to the right side again. Whether they saw something on the left side of the Charger defensive line or what the situation was, able to get the 2-point conversion with no issue. As they go to the right, get the blocking, Kutzmick does the rest of the work and gets in on the corner.
3 plays, 39 yards, 1:07, time of possession on that Avon scoring drive set up by the great punt return by Brandon Kutzmick, who also cashes in on the touchdown run. That is his 28th touchdown of the year. We'll step aside for 1 minute. This is the 9B championship football game on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. We're back at the Dakota Dome in Vermilion. 3 plays, 39 yards, 1:07. Time of possession on that scoring drive for Avon. It's a whole different ballgame now. 22-16, Chargers on top. Kutzmick, the kick. End over end. Neiman back at his own 11. And he'll slip out of one tackle, get to the left sideline. Knocked out of bounds near the 35.
Nice blocking job by Tristan Leeseth. He had one of the Avon players held up and then released the block, and that then allowed Brendan Anderson to sport to his right side and bring down Neiman.
First down, Chargers. As the Pirates closed within 6. Hamlin was thwarted on their first possession of the second half. Avon got a big punt return, set him up with good field position. Quarum on the direct snap. Maybe got back to the line of scrimmage, and that's all.
And now it looks like Avon is fired up defensively as well. All of that set up by the beautiful kick or punt return from Kutzmick. And that gave the Pirates an opportunity. Could have scored in one play, but of course had the holding penalty. And we're able to shake that off, get down the field. Kutzmick with the score on the PAT.
And that's what championship caliber teams do. When they make a mistake, they get a touchdown wiped out by a penalty. They don't hang their heads. They come right back. They march downfield and score. That's exactly what Avon did. And a short run there. Again, that direct snap to the running back, Dustin Quarum, who came into the game 1,233 yards, an impressive year with 21 rushing touchdowns, including an 80-yarder. He averages 7.3 a carry coming into this game. He's been held relatively in check. He had 65 yards at halftime on 9 carries. Not too bad, but it has been Brody Grantham who's really carried the load offensively so far today for the Chargers. He'll line up in the shotgun. Drop back. Throws. Quick pass. And it is going to be caught. But he's shy of the marker, the receiver. One of the reserve players in
Coisty.
That's been Ben Coisty, the junior wideout. Didn't get enough yardage for the first down. Close. About 2 yards short.
And the first reception of the day by Coisty, who's going to bring in the new play from Jeff Sheehan with 5:20 to go in the third quarter.
And will they go for it? No, they will not. They'll line up in punt formation. But remember, the quarterback, Grantham, is the quarterback. He's the punter.
That's too many!
Kutzmick back deep. Quick kick, a line drive. They kick it away from Kutzmick. It takes a big Hamlin bounce inside the 15. Keeps rolling to the 11-yard line. So Grantham does a great job with that punt, kicking it away from the dangerous return man for Avon.
Almost looked like he tried to pooch it a little bit, and it does look like Avon almost got a piece of the football as they sent a couple of guys there. They missed the punt and then got a beautiful roll on the Grantham punt all the way to the 10-yard line. But Avon's been in this situation certainly before, and they're fired up right now.
And Grantham got that punt away quickly. He did not delay in getting that football kicked away because the pressure was coming from the Pirates. They've got a first and 10. Right about their own 10-yard line. Kutzmick's going to try to get around the corner. He's to the 15, pulled out of bounds near the 17.
Again, trying to work the play toward the corner. The Pirates doing a decent job sealing it off. Kutzmick didn't get big yardage, but able to get the ball moving somewhat as they're going to put it at about the 17.
Coming right at you here.
Beautiful block there by Tolsma.
Beeson trying to throw a block. That was, I believe, Nankin that pulled him down. Good gain of about 7. Second and 3, Amon. Tolsma going to his left. Gets a block across the 20. He'll have a first down at the 23-yard line.
Went left side to the big guy, the strong kid Tolsma. As he took the handoff, went left side and able to get the first down to the 32-yard line. Avon down 6. They scored earlier in the quarter on the Kutzmick touchdown and 2-point conversion. 4:37 to go in the third quarter with 11B in the wings. Coming up at around 2:30 this afternoon. At least that's the scheduled start for Canton and Parkston.
They'll send running back up the middle, Tolsma. He'll get about 4 yards on the play.
Just a simple run up the gut. Push the Hamlin defense out of the way. He picks up 4. And this really changes the complexion of an offense when they're down 6 as opposed to down 14.
Absolutely. Completely different dynamic of the game. Crossing the 4-minute threshold here. Period number 3. Hamlin by 6. Avon with the ball. Mutter taking his time. Tolsma tries the left side. He'll get across the 30 and he'll be stopped at the 31.
And it looked to be Grantham who got the most of the stop, rather, for Hamlin and put the ball at the 28. Gain of roughly 5. Call it second down about 4 or 6 or 5 for the Pirates.
Third down coming up. About 3 yards to go. Kutzmick tries to get around the corner, cannot do so. Brody Grantham shut that play down, or checked that was Neiman who makes the tackle, and Kutzmick just couldn't get to the corner.
Matching him stride for stride as they race to the sideline. Neiman obviously the winner as the Pirates lose a yard.
Check out the replay coming at you again. Neiman, another big defensive play for Hamlin, and that's going to force a punt. Kutzmick will stand at his own 15. Namkin drops back to his own 35. Not much pressure applied. Another line drive, and it takes a good Avon bounce. And Namkin fumbles it. There's a pileup near the 40. It's still loose. Avon's got it. Avon football at the 35-yard line. First turnover of the game And it's a costly one for the Chargers.
If you don't watch a lot of football, as soon as the punt is touched by the return team, that is a live football. It was loose, big scrum there, and all of a sudden, it goes into the hands of Namiga, who makes the recovery, and Avon, 35 yards away and 6 points from tying the ball game.
Special teams have not gone well for Hamlin in this second half. Misdirection, Kutzmick cut down at the line of scrimmage.
Had Cole Beeson as the fullback in the wishbone situation, set him into the line on the left side. Kutzmick getting nowhere, in fact, losing about a half yard. It'll be second down and a long 10 or short 11 for the Avon squad.
Holsworth with the big tackle. Critical opportunity here for Avon as they have great field position to start this drive after the fumble. Beeson in at fullback. He'll block for Kutznick. Knife through. He's to the 30. Down near the 28-yard line. A good gain on second down for Avon.
They have worked that play very well for the better part of the day. Tristan Namkin making the tackle for the Hamlin Chargers, but they will get about 8 yards on the play, and you'll call it third down, about three to go. Need to get to the 30, or the 25, rather, for the first down. Doing a nice job was Hamlin trying to separate Kutzmick from the ball as they were trying to poke around, get the football out of his hands, but Kutzmick wouldn't have anything to do with that.
Third and about three. Fumbled snap. Mutter has to pick it up. He'll gain a yard, and that's all.
And a
wait a minute. They're saying there's a fumble.
Are they giving Hamlin the football?
Depends. The referee here will say Avon keeps it.
Progress was stopped. White ball. Fourth down.
Let's check it out on the replay here.
Fumbled snap. Just never had the snap.
Now he picks it up. Dart into the line. That's lost up in the... Well, there's the football in the hands of one of the Hamlin players.
And the runner wasn't down. It looked from here.
Really couldn't see where the ball came out, but Avon keeps it. They're going for it on fourth and two.
And I think Coach called.
Yep, timeout called by Avon.
And he'll talk things over with the rest of the Pirates. 1:09 to go. In quarter number three, Hamlin yet to score in this quarter. The Pirates have done a nice job and have really stepped things up offensively here in quarter number three.
Don't forget, you can follow SDPB Sports on your mobile device all season long. We're providing frequent updates to all South Dakota High School Championship events on Facebook and Twitter. Search SDPB Sports and hook up with us. There you see, that's what you got to look for, at SDPB Sports. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter. And and last night in volleyball, the Class AA had their regional play, so now all the brackets are set
okay.
For the high school volleyball tournament, which will start next Thursday, the 21st. We'll have coverage online at sdpb.org, culminating with the third place and championship matches from all three tournament sites on Saturday night, the 23rd, starting at 6 Central, 5 Mountain Time. Here we go, fourth down and two to go for the Pirates. Runner taking his time. Will he try to draw him off? No, he won't. Kutznick to the right side.
Got it.
First down, Avon across the 25 to the 23-yard line.
Got a couple of yards. That was all he needed. Tripped up just a little bit too late by Dylan Royer. And it'll be a first down for Avon. They are marching in with 1:04 to go. And plenty of time.
Yep, go to their main man, Brandon Kutznick. Fresh set of downs for Avon.
And as you saw in the replay, Brody Grantham involved in the tackle as well.
Avon trying to get the equalizer. This time Kutznick up the middle. He'll be stopped right away. Minimal gain.
Hamlin saw it coming right away, able to clog up the what would be the left side from Avon's perspective. Coming up with the tackle, Holsworth. A couple of other Chargers helping out. Pick up about a yard You're being generous. It'll be second down and roughly 8-9 to go. Maybe the last play of quarter number three here, Steve.
Avon, second down and 9. They'll try a pass, and it's going to be tipped and almost intercepted.
Into the hands of Tristan Laceth, knocked it away, and Namkin couldn't come up with it. That would have been a huge pick for Hamlin. Not quite. Here's Mutter to throw. There's the tip.
Laceth with the tip, and just behind Namkin, intended for Jacob Knodel, the 6'2", 210-pound junior.
And, of course, the natural reaction when you're a defender, the ball's coming your way, you're going to try to take a swat at it.
Third down and 9, Avon. He'll go to the run and Kutzmann tries to find the seam. He can't break loose. He'll be pulled down near the 16-yard line, and that's it for the third period of play. 22-16, Chargers on top after 3. This is the Class 9B Championship football game on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. One quarter left to go in this 9B championship football game. Hamlin with the edge at the moment. Avon driving here at the Dakota Dome in Vermilion. Steve Toon, Gary Ellenbolt, Mike Henriksen for this 9B championship football game. Craig Maddock will be joining us later on today for the 11B matchup. That'll follow this contest, Canton versus Parkston. And then tonight, it'll be Pier and Watertown for 11AA bragging rights. That'll start at 7 Central, 6 Mountain Time. A fourth down and 4 coming up for Avon as we start this fourth period of play.
And really a big play on both sides of the ball. Avon to keep the drive going. Hamlin to get it stopped, get the football, and try to keep it out of Avon's way the rest of the way.
Remember, Hamlin stopped him before on a fourth down situation back in the second quarter. Hamlin turned that opportunity into a touchdown. Play action. Mutter rolls out.
Not going to get it.
Nowhere close. The Hamlin defense rises to the occasion again.
That is the second big fourth down stand for the Chargers in the game. They had one in the first half that they turned into a touchdown fairly late in the second quarter. And now this one. Chargers take the ball at the 17. Mutter hit, drilled, leveled. Nowhere to go.
That was Quarum who came up. That was the first time today, really, Avon has tried that play. A fake right with the quarterback rolling out, almost on a bootleg. But it was well defended by the Chargers. Now they have it first and 10 at their own 17-yard line. Grantham up the middle, has a hole. Slips away from a tackler, gets across the 25 near the 30, first down for Hamlin.
Just a simple basic play as they sent him up the left side. Had a good hole and rolled his way to another first down. Put the ball at the 29.5-yard line with 11:48 left. Stats after three quarters. I will get that after this play. How about that?
Two receivers out to the right, one to the left for Hamlin. Quarum stays in the backfield. He'll get the direct snap. He's across the 30, down at the 34.
After three quarters, 12 first downs for Hamlin. 24 carries, 195 yards, 79 yards in the air on 4 of 8 passing. 274 total yards to 216 for Avon. The Pirates, 44 rushes, 185 yards, 31 passing yards, 1 for 2 passing. As far as rushing, Kutzmuck, the leader for the Pirates with 95 yards and a touchdown on 19 carries. Brody Grantham leading the way with 120 yards on 11 attempts for Hamlin.
Second down, 6. Quarum mishandles it, gets nailed in the backfield for a loss.
Quarum just with nowhere to go, had to hang on to the football, which is the most important thing he can do in a play like that. Avon defense goes blowing through, making the stop, and it's a third down and 8 situation.
And for Avon, making that tackle, Alex Baldwin. Third down and 8. Put a man in motion, that's Neiman. And this play is going to be blown dead, I think. I thought I heard whistles.
I thought I did, too. But it looks... Well, I don't see a flag. And they're going to go with the fourth down indicator. So, no penalty called. And
I thought there was a false start there. I thought one of the receivers turned upfield, the man in motion. But it was a run by Grantham, and he's just stopped right away by the Pirates. Tolsma in on the tackle. Punting situation for Hamlin, as Grantham will stand at his own 20. Quick kick, high kick, not very deep. It'll bounce near midfield, take a Hamlin bounce into Avon territory, then out of bounds at about the 45.
The punter Grantham does not stand very far behind the center. Normally the conventional wisdom is about 15 yards so that you don't give the other team the opportunity to block the punt, but they've kind of lived dangerously on that, and Avon has had their opportunities to block punts and get to the punter. Just haven't done it yet.
Clay Lucas bringing in the play, the senior tight end. Number 21, he and Naminga, number 23, they'll run the plays in and out for Avon. 9:37 left. Chargers by six. Pirates with the ball in good field position. Mutter wants the throw, lobs it. He's got a man, it's gonna be caught! Cutsmick tumbled down inside the 15-yard line.
Well, Avon is proving they can pass the ball when they have to. Cutsmick had about three steps on the defender, and he was able to come up. There's the play action. Enough of the defender's bit. There's the long pass into the hands of Cutsmick. And Cutsmick puts it deep into Hamlin territory. Ball at the Charger 14.
And credit Neiman with a touchdown-saving tackle as he lunged out and managed to grab the foot of Cutsmick. Otherwise, that was going to be a touchdown for Avon, but they're in business. First and 10 at the 14-yard line. Up the middle, Tolsma. Tough yardage. Plows ahead. Down to the 10.
Ball is loose.
Ball's loose.
Hamlin's
and Hamlin's got it! Oh my goodness, what a turn of events. It's Quarum coming out of the pile with the football, and Tolsma fumbles it away. A huge break for Hamlin.
And for the third time today, they have stopped a deep Avon drive. There goes the ball.
Yeah, ball came out, knee wasn't down. Didn't appear to be down, and Hamlin forces a turnover. They got it at their own 9-yard line. First and 10 with 9:04 left. Grantham on the keeper. Runs into a whole host of white jerseys and will lunge ahead for a couple of yards.
And Hamlin's not going to do anything risky with the football. There's a lot of time in this game and just a 6-point lead for the Chargers, but they're going to try to run in, get the first downs, chew up just as much time as they can here. And now an official's timeout as one of the Avon players is going to be looked at.
That's Josh Knodel, number 72, the 235-pound defensive tackle.
Anderson will take his place, number 22 for 72, on a second down and six situation for Hamlin.
Yep, forward progress got him across the 12-yard line. Long six to go for Hamlin. It's Anderson. Lines up on the defensive line for Hamlin. And Hamlin's going to let some time roll now. The run by Grantham up the middle. He'll get across the 15, shy of the marker by about 4 yards.
Just a short run, headed up the middle. Coming up with the stop, Jake Knodel. The Pirates now watching Hamlin try to take care of a third down and four situation. They've had the 2-yard runs, and they seem to have those down, but they need about four right here.
Grantham had 1,158 yards on the season coming into this game. He and Quarum for 1-2 punch, and Grantham is the bulk of the carries today. Quarum, direct snap, gets around the corner, first down, hit hard across the 30 by Logan Mutter. Down at the 35, first down, Chargers.
Just a tasty bit of running by Dustin Quarum. He took the handoff, did the rest of the work, and that is a big play. Look how that one comes around. Great camera work down there, guys. Rolls right side, able to shake off Cutsford for a while, but couldn't get around Mutter. First down and 10 regardless. The Chargers hang on. 7:30 to go.
Hamlin got a seal around the right side, and it just opened up that entire side of the field. He had a big alley to run through, did Quero. They'll bring a man in tight. That's Neiman, quarterback keeper, and Grantham gets cut down at the line of scrimmage. No gain.
And a very nice job by Anderson and a couple of other Pirates to smell that out right away. Grantham nowhere to go. Didn't gain anything. Didn't lose anything either. It'll be second down, 10 to go. Keep the ball at the Charger 35, 7 minutes to play. It's a good game.
It has been a fantastic 9B game, and now you can start seeing it in the crowd. The Pirate fans and even some of the Charger fans, after every play, they take a look at that clock winding down. Hamlin, second and 10. They'll put Neiman in motion, bring him in as a running back, and we have a false start.
All start is going to be the call. It's the fifth time Hamlin has been dead whistled ball for an illegal
ball
procedure.
Start, blue, 5-yard penalty.
And they've been coming at fairly inopportune times for the Chargers, too.
That helps Avon a bunch. It stops the clock momentarily, and it backs the Chargers up 5. Now the clock will be put in motion once again. Second and 15 coming up for the team in blue, the Hamlin Chargers. Neiman comes in motion, two backs. Direct snap, Quero tries to get to the right. He's hemmed in, brought down by a host of Pirates.
Josh Knodel, one of the guys there. Brother Jake helping out as well. And helping out on the stop was Alex Bolvin as they just wrapped up. The ball carrier nowhere to go for the Chargers. Now they've got a really fascinating call to make on third down and 15 from the 28-yard line.
Yep, do they try a pass or they play it safe and try to run it? Why do you try to use up some more clock? Grantham out of the gun. He'll run it up the middle. They play it safe. They'll get across the 30-yard line to the 31, but nowhere near the first down marker, not even back to the original line of scrimmage. A punting situation coming up for the Chargers.
Do they need a great punt or what here?
Well, the question is for Avon. They've got a man in Kutzmick who already has one great punt return. Do you bring the pressure or do you try to set up the return if you're Avon? Looks like Avon's going to set up for the return.
And if you kick it, I mean, do you try to keep it away from Kutzmick as much as you can?
I think you do. I think you aim it for the sidelines. Oh, bad punt off the side of the foot. Not very far.
That might have been partially deflected, too.
It'll bounce across midfield to the 44-yard line. That's where Hamlin will have it, Avon will have it, first and 10 when we come back from this timeout. You're watching the Class 9B Championship football game on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Coming down the stretch here at the 9B championship football game. Fourth quarter, Steve Toon, Gary Ellenbolt, Mike Henriksen. It's been a dandy of a game between Hamlin and Avon. Pirates have it after a short punt by Hamlin. First and 10 Avon from their own 45-yard line. Play action. Mutter throws the deep ball. He's got a man. Tolsma. Incomplete. Penalty flag is down.
Oh, my goodness. Penalty flag is down. And one of these teams, likely Hamlin, going to get it for pass interference.
It appeared there was contact. Let's check it out. Good play action by Logan Mutter. It's only his second pass attempt of the game. Yep, clear contact right there. Mike Namkin, the guilty party. And that's going to be pass interference against Hamlin.
And that is going to give Avon an automatic first down.
Pass interference. Blue defense. 15-yard penalty. For the first down.
15 yards in the first down. The ball is going to go to the 40-yard line now. And Hamlin needs to work its defensive magic again.
Yep, ball put down right at the 41-yard line of the Chargers. First down, Avon. As they went to a pass coming out of the timeout. Both teams with two timeouts to work with. Mutter will hand off to Cutsmith. Has a little bit of an alley to the 35. Pulled down around the 34-yard line.
And a great play on first down to get 7 or 8 yards. And as we've touched on a couple of games today, that really opens up the offense and the playbook. They'll pick up 7 on the play. Holdsworth of the tackle for the Hamlin squad. It'll be 2nd down, 3 to go. Need to get to the 31 for the first down.
2nd, 2. Option. Cutsmith had to wait for it. Slips and falls back at the 37.
Had Austin Neiman back there, but Neiman never laying a hand on him and didn't need to. Cutsmith got the pitch, bobbled it a bit. They fake it into the line. There's the pitch. And Cutsmith just too many irons in the fire as he slipped and fell on the Dakota Dome turf. And we've talked about those turf tackles here at this unusual surface at the Dome.
Yeah, that pitch was behind Cutsmith. He had to kind of reach back. It threw off his balance. And then when he tried to hit upfield, he just lost his footing. 3rd down. Cutsmith going to throw. Looking downfield. Got a man in traffic. It's incomplete. Double coverage down there for Naminga, the intended receiver. From now, decision time for Culver. Coach Culver, you think they're going to go for it here on 3rd down and about 7.
Some really great coverage from Quirum. There's the pump fake by Cutsmer. He escapes one defender, fires it downfield. Everybody going for the ball, and everybody has a right to it in the air. And an incomplete pass. 4th down, 7 to go.
I think Coach Culver is going to spend a timeout here as his team's looking to the sideline.
And this play could very well mean the game, so they want to make sure that everybody is on the same particular page.
And a timeout called by Avon. They only have 1 left with 3:22 on the clock here at the Dakota Dome. Say, coming up on Saturday night after the 11 AAA championship game, it's No Cover, No Minimum, featuring Sheryl Crow. SDPB recorded her performance at this year's Jazz Fest, presented by the Sioux Falls Jazz and Blues Society. Stay with us on Saturday night after the Lincoln Roosevelt football game for Sheryl Crow, a magnificent performance. Gotta check it out Saturday night.
And a great way to wrap up Saturday after a busy weekend of football.
You bet. 7 championship high school football games here at the Dome. Plus, there's that college game between USD and SDSU here on Saturday afternoon. So, football, if you want it, Vermilion's the place to be.
And South Dakota may have its first ever traffic jam outside 41st Street in Sioux Falls tomorrow in Vermilion, with everything going on for people.
Here we go, 4th down and 7. Mutter drops back to throw, lobs it downfield. It's going to be intercepted by Quirum. He'll take it to the middle of the field and be pulled down at the 21-yard line.
There is still a lot of time for Avon to get on the scoreboard, but that didn't help matters as they went long for the pass. On 4th down and 7, Mutter gets it off, underthrows his receiver, and there's Quirum, played it perfectly and came up with the pick.
Mutter had time to throw. The protection was good, just underthrew the pass. 1st down, 10, Hamlin from their own 21. For the first time today, they stack it up in the eye. They'll hand off. That'll be Quirum with the carry, and he'll get a couple of yards. Let's see if Avon will spend a timeout here. They only have 1 left. They'll let it roll.
Might be a little early, I'm thinking, for the timeout right now. And the Chargers not about to stop the clock.
No, and they will work every possible second off that clock that they can before they snap the football. 2nd down, we'll call it 8. Traditional set here for Hamlin. Grantham taking his time. He'll keep it. Look for a seam. Can't find one. Tackled right at the 23. That is the line of scrimmage. And now the timeout has been called.
Tolsma making the tackle. And this is a timeout that'll benefit Avon and could certainly benefit Hamlin as well, because now they've got a third down in about eight situation. They want to keep the ball, want to get the first down. And with the first down, you'd have to think the Pirates are really going to have to scramble to get the win here.
Yep, for Avon, this is almost a do-or-die third down defensively. They are out of timeouts. They need to stop the Chargers here. What a great game this has been. Don't forget, this is the first of three today on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. The afternoon game will be 11B, Canton versus Parkston. Both teams also known for running the football almost exclusively.
Both teams with one loss on the year.
And that was Canton losing to Parkston. Early on, that was a seven-point decision in favor of Parkston. Tonight, it's Pier and Watertown. Our coverage begins at 7 Central, 6 Mountain time. That's for 11AA.
The Arrows and the Governors. Pier making its first appearance at the Dome for a state championship since 2001. Watertown hasn't been here since 2005.
Play action. Grantham rolls out. He'll keep it, trying to get outside. He can't.
He was close, but Tolsma able to string out the play at about the 25. Penalty flag down.
And I believe Watertown was last here in 2001. I just want to check the record here
okay.
Quickly. 2001 was Watertown over Brookings.
No flag on the play.
No penalty flag.
I might have had that backwards. Maybe Pier was the 2005.
Nope, 2005 was O'Gorman and Yankton. Pier was last year in 89.
Okay.
When they lost to Brandon, or check that, 88 when they lost to O'Gorman.
Fourth down and six situation. And the Chargers, 2-11 to hang on for the win.
Pressure coming at Grantham, wisely kicked it very quickly. Didn't let the punt team for Avon get anywhere close to them. Now it goes out of bounds at the 45-yard line. 2:04 left. Avon has good field position. They are out of timeouts, but with this field position, they do not have to abandon their running game.
You know, Grantham almost has to get the ball off quickly, as short as the distance is between himself and the long snapper, because he's got to get rid of it, and he has faced some pressure on just about every punt today.
Avon approaches the line. First and 10, and now they're going to go to a spread formation for the first time today. Four wideouts, and I think, does Hamlin spend a timeout? Yes, they
timeout
will.
White.
They want to set up some defensive alignment. Pirates have no more.
You know, and Hamlin, they want to make sure their defense is set here, as Avon, they've been lining up in the wishbone set all day. First time today they've gone to a spread formation, and Hamlin hadn't seen that. So they've got one timeout left. Might as well spend it on defense. Say Frontline marks the 50th anniversary of the Kennedy assassination with a two-hour reprise of one of its investigative biographies of the man at the center of the political crime of the 20th century, Lee Harvey Oswald. Was he the lone assassin of President Kennedy? Did he act with others? Or was he, as he famously claimed at a news conference, a patsy? Watch Frontline Tuesday night, 9 Central, 8 Mountain Time on South Dakota Public Broadcasting, SDPB1 Television.
There have been a lot of programs and specials on the 50th anniversary of the Kennedy assassination. And I know Morning Edition and NPR will do an awful lot on that, and we'll have a local story with South Dakota reaction from people who remember where they were 50 years ago.
All right, back to football here as Mutter lines up in the shotgun. He'll keep it, try to get to the left side, cut it up the middle, nothing doing. Maybe got 2 yards on the play, and that's all.
That was a great defensive play, too, by the Hamlin Chargers. As they roll to the right side, Brody Grantham on one side, Leeseth on the other, just sealed them off. Gain of 2, minute 43 to go.
Second down and 8. Mutter again, out of the shotgun. Will he throw? He lets back to throw. Throws the deep ball. He's got a man, and there's penalty flag down. Incomplete. But there was pass interference. Tolsma, the intended receiver.
Ryder Grantham back on the defense. He and Tolsma matching each other all the way down the field, but the flag down at the 22-yard line, and that will be a pass interference penalty, and it goes on the Chargers.
You see on the replay, clear contact before the football
pass arrived. Interference, defense, 15-yard penalty.
That also stops the clock with a minute and a half to go.
In high school, you don't get the ball at the spot of the infraction. It's just a straight 15-yard penalty. So they still have about 38 yards to go to get the score and a minute and a half to get it done.
Mutter with Beeson standing next to him in the backfield. Four-man rush. Here it comes. Overthrown. Incomplete. They try to go on a little crossing pattern to Kutzmick at the 35, but it was over his head.
Kutzmick was there, Tolsma in the area as well. Just a long, loud incompletion, making it second down and 10. Keep the ball at the 38 and a minute 18. Time a wasting for the Pirates.
Four-man on the line of scrimmage defensively. Mutter stares over the defense, fakes the handoff, throws the screen pass. Beeson has it. He's at the 30. He gets to the sideline. He's down the sideline. Touchdown, Avon!
What a move by Beeson. As he's coming down the sideline, fakes out a couple of Hamlin defenders. And we are a two-point conversion from overtime.
And Beeson appears to be shaken up. He's limping back to the sideline. He was scheduled to start. It's a last-minute scratch from the lineup as Anderson replaced him. But Beeson comes off the bench. They fake the handoff to him. He swings to the outside. Got to the sideline. Got a block from Kutzmick. And into the end zone. A touchdown for Cole Beeson, the junior.
Timeout called. And Hamlin calling its final timeout with a minute 8 left. The biggest play of the game is coming up here on that two-point conversion. You get it, you likely win. You don't get it, you'll likely go to overtime and some more free football. We have not had an overtime game in several years. The last person to win an OT was Canton.
Was that 06?
Yes, 06 against 2006. Del Rapids, 11A final.
This has been a sensational 9B championship game, and we're not done yet. Canton and Parkston waiting in the wings. That's the 11B matchup. That is scheduled for around a 2:30 kickoff.
I'm guessing that's not going to happen.
No, I don't think that's going to happen either. So
if we go to overtime, I know it won't.
Yes. We still got a ways to go over this one. An important two-point conversion coming up for Avon. They're back in their traditional set. Up the middle. Tolsma's got it. Avon with the lead.
They had their opportunity to bring Tolsma down at about the 1 yard line. Didn't get a chance to ramp up on him. And Devin Tolsma bouncing off the tacklers, taking a step to his right. And in he goes. A 2-point lead for Avon.
Back to their traditional run. And Tolsma powers his way into the end zone. The Pirates up by 2 with a minute 8 left. Nobody has any timeouts left. Hamlin will have to operate in a hurry when they get the football back. What a game this has been. The first of 3 today on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. And in case you're wondering, I don't think Hamlin has kicked a field goal all year. Luis Marcos Spiegelberg is their kicker, 14 of 18 on point after attempts, but no field goals. Otherwise, you figure if they even got close to a field goal attempt, it would be Grantham.
Big return needed here by the Chargers. Here's the advance, and Kutzmick's kick.
It's going to bounce at the 20, picked up by Hamlin. And cut down across the 30. At the 33 is Neiman.
You know, this is just how a game featuring a couple of undefeated teams should go.
Absolutely. Down to the wire. Somebody will win their fifth championship. Somebody will win or have their third perfect season in this contest. Hamlin went perfect in 91 and 96. Avon, they were perfect in 02 and 05. Both teams have won four championships. Grantham out of the shotgun, throws the long ball and holds up, and it will be short, incomplete.
Just a little bit underthrown, had the intended receiver down the left side and just not able to get there. Good job on the defense as the Avon defenders able to prevent the completion, which would have been difficult anyway.
Avon was down 22-8. Well, we got a penalty flag down on the field. Holding defense. So that's going to be a 5-yard walk-off and an automatic first down. Let's check out the official signal.
Defensive holding, White, 10-yard penalty.
Oh, 10-yard penalty.
It'll be a defensive holding, and that will give Hamlin a bit of a break, move them closer to the end zone, but they've got work to do, too, with 58 seconds left.
So the original line of scrimmage was the 33. They'll move it up to the 43-yard line of Hamlin. Chargers will have it there, first and 10. 58 seconds on the clock, and again, no timeouts for anybody. Two receivers either side. As Grantham looks to throw, and it is incomplete. The only player that really had a chance for that was the defensive back, Naminga, for Avon.
And so a long, loud incompletion, but only 7 seconds off the clock. Difficult but doable for the Chargers, who have just played their hearts out, and really both teams have. And what a run to get things taken care of on the tying touchdown that came into the hands of Cole Beeson. And
now officials timeout. We got an equipment repair.
And Jeff Sheehan is talking things over. He's talking with one of his players, and that, of course, would be Grantham, the quarterback. And he's also saying a couple of things of the looks to the official. And now one of the officials is going over. I think Coach Sheehan wanted a penalty in that pass play.
I think Coach, I'm not sure what he's talking about with the official, but nonetheless, the equipment repair for Avon is essentially a free timeout for Hamlin. It gets a chance to regroup, and we'll have a substitution in as checking out is Chambers as Grantham gets the snap. Out of the gun, thinks about a pass, he'll tuck and run. Can he get to the sideline? He breaks free, and he gets out of bounds across midfield.
Knew exactly where he had to go for the first down. Got the yardage, moved the sticks.
And more importantly, he stopped the clock with 41 seconds left. A nice scramble by Grantham. Pulls away from Tolsma, who normally a good tackler, just couldn't tackle him in bounds. Boy, if Tolsma makes that tackle in bounds, I don't think he gets the first down, plus the clock keeps rolling. But Grantham made a huge play, not just breaking the tackle, but getting to the sideline and stopping the clock. Out of the shotgun, Grantham looks left, throws, and it's underthrown, incomplete.
Trying to set up somebody, that was Ryder Grantham on the left side. That was a tough throw from all the way across the field, and it wasn't close to Grantham, but a very nice job on the defense as well by Naminga.
So that's second and 10, 36 seconds left. We saw some trick plays last night in the 11A game down the stretch where West Central got a touchdown with 19 seconds left on a halfback pass. See if Hamlin's got anything in their bag of tricks down by two. They'll throw down the right sideline, and it is gonna be incomplete, almost picked off by Avon.
It was right there as they had somebody back on the defense. They were getting as many people as possible on the ball carrier. Logan Mutter was the guy who just about had the pick. There's the pass. Mutter in great position and just knocked away from him. as he caught the ball by the intended receiver for Hamlin.
That was Namkin, who actually almost himself turning into a defensive back, knocking the ball loose from the defensive player who was on the verge of making an interception. Third down and 10. Grantham throws under pressure and is intercepted by Avon Naminga to midfield. And he'll be pulled down at the 41-yard line. What a play by Cody Naminga, the junior.
Another short pass, and Naminga just in great shape to get it. Came right to him, waited for it, caught it, and came the other way. And it looks like Avon will be your 9B state champion. They just have to hang on for 21 more seconds. What a game.
What a game. Just one. We'll probably see the victory formation. Check it out on the replay here. A little bit of pressure coming. Grant or Ryder Grantham, the intended receiver. And it was Naminga jumping the route. Yes, the victory formation coming up for Avon. All they have to do is take one knee. And this one's over. Mutter covers up the football. Hamlin out of timeouts. This ball game is over, and what a game it has been. Congratulations to the Avon Pirates. Their third perfect season in school history, during the playoff era at least, and their fifth championship. The Pirates are victorious.
You know, I avoid cliches like the plague, Steve, but this is one of those games, it's a shame someone had to lose it.
Absolutely.
And especially losing in the late minutes as Hamlin did. Hamlin at one time had a 22-8 lead.
Credit the Pirate defense. They shut out Hamlin for the entire second half. Boy, just almost a replay of what happened last night. Madison got out early on West Central. They were up by two scores. Only in that game, West Central cut it to a one-score game at halftime. But West Central shut out Madison in the second half. Here, Avon shuts out Hamlin in the second half to claim another nine-man championship.
The two teams shaking hands, exchanging good game, good game, good game, good game. And the Pirates celebrating as well they should. They get it done in the late minutes and get the decision.
Cole Beeson, who was scheduled to start, didn't play a whole lot in this game. He did play in the second half. The 200-pound junior fullback catches the game-winning touchdown pass, or the game-tying touchdown pass, and then Devin Tolsma cashes in on the two-point conversion, a run up the middle, and Avon's your champions. We're going to have some hardware handed out. Let's turn it over to Greg Merrigan. He is our public address announcer.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I direct your attention to the center of the playing field to present the awards to the 2013 runner-up and championship teams for Class 9B football. Our members of the Board of Directors of the South Dakota High School Activities Association, and assisting with the awards are members of the Activity Association's corporate partners, Trig Odney from Sanford Health, Brian Hermson from Farmers Union Insurance, and Sergeant First Class Mark Roberts from the South Dakota Army National Guard. And to accept the runner-up trophy, they finished the year with an outstanding record of 11-1 in this exciting 9B championship game. Head coach Jeff Sheehan and the Hamlin Chargers. And our Class 9B champions finished the year with a perfect 12-0 record. Head coach Tom Culver and the Avon Pirates. And now the individual awards. Each year, the members of the media covering the state championship games select the Joe Robbie MVP, the outstanding performer in the championship game. Jim Brady, representing the Vermilion Chamber of Commerce, will make the presentation. Our Joe Robbie MVP had a big day today. He rushed 16 times for 94 yards, one touchdown, and he had 16 tackles. The Joe Robbie MVP, Devin Tolsma of Avon. The South Dakota High School Coaches Association selects an outstanding lineman and an outstanding back in each of the championship games. The Coaches Association has selected as the outstanding lineman Alex Holdsworth of Hamlin High School. And the coaches have selected Brandon Kutzmick of Avon as the outstanding back in this championship game. Both teams will move to their respective end zones for an official team photo. After the conclusion of that, fans are able to join their teams on the field.
And welcome back to the Dakota Dome. We are on the floor here with Tom Culver. First of all, Tom, congratulations.
Thanks. I worked up a sweat this afternoon, I know that.
Listen. Throwing the ball isn't all that bad, is it?
No, you know, the old story, you know, you throw it, three things happen, two are bad. Well, it happened twice today, but I mean, they were playing up so tight and we had to do something different in the second half and we knew we were going to have to throw the ball, so it worked out good.
Talk about this Hamlin team because this was as good a 9B game as we've seen in a long time.
Yeah, they're a very good team. I mean, they're athletic and they play hard and well coached, and you know Jeff does a great job with them, and you know I'm just happy. You know at halftime I told our kids the last thing before we went out for the kickoff. I said last night West Central was down by 14 and a half, and they came back. I said there's no reason we can't either. So and they did.
And by the way, the chance of both West Central and Avon winning on a touchdown pass. You'd get pretty long odds on that, Tom.
Yeah, I would. Maybe I should buy a lottery ticket or something. But yeah, you don't see that very often. Maybe Coach Utek was my inspiration with his play calling last night.
All right. So, what does this team mean to you?
Well, I'm really happy with them because they come a long ways. You know, we were playing a lot of sophomores and juniors last year, and they, we end up 6-4, and you know, they just. They hadn't got that work ethic and stuff that, you know, we expect out of our kids. And to their credit, they did that this year and they worked hard. And, and they've come a long ways. I couldn't be happier for them.
Well, Tom, congratulations again. Go celebrate with the team.
All right. Thanks, Mike.
Tom Culver, the head coach of the Avon Pirates, wrapping up the perfect season for the Pirates. And Tom, a regular down here at the Dakota Dome. We're back with more postgame right after this timeout. You're watching the South Dakota High School Championships on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
Welcome back inside the Dakota Dome. A great 9B championship game concludes with Avon beating Hamlin 24-22. And surprise, surprise, it's a pass play that wins the game for Avon.
And what an amazing pass play it was. What a great 9B final we had here. The 9P teams, just like a couple of fighters, duking it out to the very final minutes. Avon getting the last punch in with the score and the two-point conversion. As far as the Pirates' statistics, 195 yards on the ground, 111 passing yards. They should shut Avon down and have a parade with a number like that. 306 total yards of the game. They were actually outgained by Hamlin, 330 to 306. Time of possession pretty close, favoring Avon by a bit. For the Chargers, 16 first downs, 251 rushing yards, 79 through the air, and 330 total yards with 2304 their time of possession.
And how even was this game? Three different players gathering the individual awards. Kutzmick, the most valuable back. Holsworth from Hamlin, the most valuable lineman. And the Joe Robbie winner is Devin Tolsma. Stats pretty doggone even throughout this contest. Kutzmick ended up with 99 yards on the ground on 21 carries. Tolsma, 94 yards on 16 carries. Meanwhile, Brody Grantham with 20 carries for 154 yards. And Justin Quarum had 97 yards on 18 carries. Grantham was 4 of 12 passing, 1 interception, 2 touchdowns, and 79 yards. Checking out the second half highlights.
And here's how it gets started. Kutzmer once again, part of his 99 yards on the day. Gets into the end zone, scores the touchdown. See a little bit of a worried look on Jeff Sheehan.
There's a long pass that was intercepted by Quarum, and it looked like Avon, their hopes might have been dashed at that point, but they managed to force a punt from Hamlin. They got the ball back, and then the little swing pass.
Watch this run.
To Beeson, gets a block, gets another block. Down the sidelines, Cole Beeson, that tied the game, and then the Pirates had to go for two. Devin Tolsma cashes in, and the Pirates with their fifth championship.
And the dynasty continues in Avon, South Dakota, as the Pirates defeat the Hamlin Chargers. Final 24-22. Avon completes an undefeated 12-0 season.
We'll take a timeout, come back with more. This is the 9B Championship football game on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Congratulations to the Pirates of Avon. They claim their fifth championship, wrap up their third perfect season. A classic football game here at the Dakota Dome. 24-22, the final score. A very exciting win over Hamlin, making their first appearance in the Dome since 1999. This the first of three games today here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Canton and Parkston, that's our next matchup coming up in the 11B contest. And then tonight, it will be Watertown taking on Pierre.
That's the Friday session. On Saturday, you will see Sioux Falls Lincoln and Sioux Falls Roosevelt. That will be for the new 11 AAA class championship, one of those teams making history as the first 11 AAA champion of the modern era. We're figuring about a 305 start for the 11B final, Steve.
Yeah, that's a rough estimate on our part here, but we're going to bring you some Dakota life as the team celebrate. We'll clear the field, and then it'll be Canton and Parkston coming up in a bit. This is South Dakota Public Broadcasting.